Hey, what's up everyone, Arvid here. Today we'll be doing something different. We'll be doing a portfolio review, and this is actually a stream which I did on Twitch a while back, but I just thought I edited it a bit, make it a bit more appealing and upload it to YouTube so everyone on YouTube can have a look as well. And the cool thing is I have a special guest, which is a good friend of mine, which is Dennis Miller, who is a very talented artist right now working at Sony Imageworks. He was also my colleague at ILM. So he's definitely a senior artist and he definitely knows what he's talking about. So it's great to have him on the stream. So be sure to check out his portfolio and then let's get going.
Hey guys, I'm Dennis. I'm a senior lighting artist here in Vancouver at Sony Imageworks. And I'm excited to join my buddy Arvid today.
Okay, so yeah, why don't you talk about a few of your shots and then we can get going.
Oh yeah, this is like a collection of my latest work. It was, most of the stuff was done at Industrial Light and Magic here in Vancouver. I got lucky and worked on the latest Star Wars movie, even if the movie wasn't that that great. It was quite fun working on it. And yeah, like mostly at IMM I worked on the latest Aladdin movie. I worked on Irishman. And this is some older stuff from 2016 where I worked at the Walt Disney Animation Studios in Los Angeles on Moana. And it was a really, really special project. It was really fun and visually was really, really nice and challenging. And as you can see, I have quite a variety from like more cartoony stuff to super photoreal stuff like The Irishman. And then something in between like Bumblebee. And I enjoy lighting. I like everything that is related to color and composition. And I'm not so much on the technical side as Arvid. I'm really into shot work and trying to get like the most out of every shot and storytelling. And that's it so far. I hope you enjoy.
Yeah, pretty impressive stuff. Mine is definitely not so colorful. I've just have I've got cool stuff, but I would love to work in animation at some point again. So we'll see if how the transition will be from feature film to back to feature anim, but we will see how it goes. And first of all, I want to thank everyone who joined the chat or the live stream. We've got now 51 people watching, which is a quite large sum of people, which is nice. So today we will be doing some portfolio reviews. And how it will work is, as you can see here in the corner, we have this magic hat. And what I did and all the emails I received, I got around like 60, 70 emails regarding portfolio review. So how it will work, we can't obviously do all the reviews. I will have this magic hat and it will pick a name and then it will remove, the name will be then removed from the hat. So it will not be picked twice. And then we open up the email, open up the link, and then we talk about it. Ideally, the person is in the chat or in the stream as well, so he can give some feedback. And I think in future iterations of the portfolio reviews, we will be on a Zoom call or some kind of meeting so we can actually see the participant in the view as well. But we see how it will go. All right, so I'm not sure, we can maybe wait a few more minutes and I can just respond to a few chats here. How do you mean, Jimmy, who is Elaine? Yeah, so...
And thanks for the nice words about the rear. Luchowski,
yeah. And I hope you like the nice purple color today. I've always tried to randomize the color so we always have something refreshing there. So yeah, we'll see. Okay. So let me just, I'm just clicking here. So the first one is Ramiro Rafael Restre. So now comes the good thing where I need to find him in those tons of emails. But I think I got him. All right.
Let's see what we got.
Okay. The good thing is that he did not send anything. Oh no, he's got something here. Sorry. He got a PDF. Okay. PDF is fine.
Let's check it.
So
he's a 3D artist. It looks like 3D portfolio. That's good. See what we got here.
The only question is how do I there download. All right. Put it on desktop.
With some kind of viewer, right? Oh, looks, he looks like he's a modeler.
Yeah, and one thing to say is that we are both more on looked at lighting side, but we can totally give some modeling feedback. We have more talented people in modeling, like Andrew Hodgins, who is actually doing also portfolio reviews. So why doesn't it open? I think it's a large file, is it?
And maybe it's a virus.
26 megabytes or a virus. Let's see, why is that opening? The first time streamer issues here. There we go. Now it's opening. Okay, now let me see.
Oh, it looks pretty cool.
I drop it in here.
Boom. All like, right. Zoom in a little bit.
I can click here.
Ooh. Ooh.
Okay. So, Rafael, let me remove him from the hat. Item removed. Then we go in. So, let me do this on full here. And you can see us in the corner. All right, so let's just have a quick look what we see here, first of all.
So it looks like Rafael is a modeler in the first place. And it looks like he's recreating stuff from previous movies, which was a really good exercise. And yeah, it looks,
Ninja Trolls,
so. Looks pretty cool on the first glimpse.
And so, but I would say first, what thing is which I see with this one here with... is that Magneto, I think? Yeah, that the helmet is a bit too loose on his head, even though it looks in a reference that that there is a gap here. It's just really a shadow, I would say. It's not that there is like so much gap in between. So that the helmet looks a bit too large for whatever I'm seeing here on the references. But let's go in here. Yeah, okay. So I'm not sure if he wants just modeling feedback or if he's actually looked at. Let me see if he's in that. I don't see him. I would say for a modeling standpoint, it's pretty good. On the texture, like at least for him here, for Patrick Stewart, like the shading and the texturing is not really close to the reference. It looks very cartoony almost, and especially that metal thing on his head here is really not that good looking. It looks very simple and there's no breakups and nothing like that. Go in here. Best friend portrait.
Looks close. Pretty good.
Oh, it's a pretty long thing.
There's a lot of like a painterly look, or was like,
I think he's going for a painted look here.
It looks like it, right? It's like a, like, okay, like this, like, is obviously is like a painting and he tries to
replicate that.
Replicate. What always is important also is like, if you submit your reel or portfolio or whatever, it's always good to have like a first chart that says like, what are you actually doing? Like, it's like, I'm like, for example, I was right, I'm Dennis, I'm a lighting artist. And then underneath the shots, I'm writing what kind of task I did, just briefly, and then you can do like a more elaborate breakdown. I mean, here it's pretty obvious he did like lighting and look depth, but sometimes it's like, for example, with a painterly look, it would have like, oh, I'm trying to achieve this painterly look on this image, so you know, okay, this is what he's going for, and at least for the point where it ain't obvious. But yeah, like the models look pretty cool, and also I would love to see like if it gets really into modeling, like to see like wireframe or like a 3D turntable. And I always like to see moving images, like even if it's just a turntable or like to get like
shadows and stuff.
Yeah, because it's always hard to judge stuff from the 2D image. But yeah, overall, I think it's a pretty good portfolio.
As Dennis said, it's always important to showcase your best work. And like, it depends, like if this is a look dev reel, I would say it's not really that great because there's so many issues, especially on Patrick Stewart here. But if it's a modeling reel, I would say it's pretty good. Like as Dennis said as well, we don't see any wireframes, so that is a bit tricky to judge how the modeling process is. In terms of matching references, it is pretty good, but I'm obviously missing all the details, like poor details and wrinkles and whatnot. Also, it seems like the grooming, or I'm not sure if this hair here was groomed or if it's just a texture. It feels very straight and there's no breakup in terms of the hair. Overall, definitely this one especially needs some work on the Vans logo here, which is just super bright. And like things like that are really distracting because you would not see that for real, right? So it would never be as bright as, it's almost like a value of one here, which is way too much. Let's see.
Also, like for the painterly stuff, I kind of like it. I think it's cool. For me, it would be interesting, okay, how did you achieve it? Is this also like, this is a 2D image? Is it just like a Photoshop filter? Or would this actually work in 3D where you kind of like pan around the character and it still would hold up to this? So it's quite interesting.
Yeah, you can keep going. You can scroll here as well.
Yeah, right? Oh, okay, let me like.
So just unclick. No scroll.
Okay, that's it. So it's like we got this, and yeah, overall I think yeah, for like modeling, there's some areas for improvement. Like for example, like this stuff looks a little bit. It's lacking a little bit of detail, and it, of course you can always push stuff that you go more, especially on the cloth, you go more into the wrinkling, and then you can like, yeah, you can really push the level of detail. But like, I mean, it's definitely he's recognizable. You catch the main areas, and yeah, it's pretty decent, I would say. Yeah. I mean, like the next step would be like pick 1, 2, 3 of your favorite assets and then really try how far you can push it, right? Try to really, okay, how far, like if you look at this is a reference, and this guy, you see like he is more detailed on the neck area and all the I don't even know what all these things are called, like the
neck is fine.
Yeah, but like these
oh, the scales.
And yeah, it's like try something and then see, take one hero asset and try how far you can get with it and really push it to the max. And then do a 3D turntable, because like this is all good work. It's just, yeah, good basis, but there's always room to improvement. And it's always good when studios look at things, it's like if you have like one or two projects that are really like elaborated and really, yeah, like super detailed and super high and finished, it will give you like a better start as if you have like five projects that are kind of that are good but like that are still in the rough a little bit.
What I can say for the Ninja Turtle here, one thing is that it looks very symmetrical. It looks actually that it's just mirrored from in the X direction, which is a bit a shame because nothing is perfectly mirrored. So maybe that's something you guys need to work on, is just break up your shapes, like especially in the final stage, you can just break up the patterns. And you can see in the reference here of the turtle, it's not all symmetrical, like there's different heights of different objects. So keep that in mind if you do your objects to make them really work and realistic, is definitely to break up the symmetry. Yeah, so I think if there are any more questions on this, I'm not sure. I think I have seen him in the chat, Ramiro, because I think he said thanks, but I'm not super sure. So let's just go back into here full screen. So this was the first portfolio review, and yeah, I think it worked pretty well.
Yeah, overall, like it's really good work. It's yeah, congrats, keep going, and yeah, like definitely not far from getting a job, or like if you want to go for it, it's pretty cool stuff.
Right now, we do not have any portfolio submissions anymore, just because we have our random picks here in the email. So right now, we don't accept any more submissions. I think that's it. So let's just go to the main scene here. So we have been talking about this item for now, and we will just be picking a new hat here. Let me just go back quickly to the email, which died, I believe. There you go. Let me just move him. All right, so let's pick a new one. So you can see the head is thinking, checking, and let's do it. So next up is Peck Andre. Let's see. We got actually like around 80 submissions, so it's quite a lot. So let's see if we can find Peck Andre. It was the person who submitted the second reel, so he's one of the early persons. And we have actually, it looks like a video or not, ArtStation. Oh, looks cool. Let me just bring this over here. Andre. Right, maybe we do this. We just have a quick look and then we can make it full screen. Can we go next here like this?
Yeah, yeah. It works, right? So it looks like he's more coming from the lighting look dev side for sure, right?
Yeah, I would say so.
Say anything?
I think there's an about section. That's his name. Not much. 3D modeling, visualization,
texturing, rendering, lighting. Okay, like it's in the ballpark.
Generalist, I would say.
Okay.
All right, portfolio. Okay, let's just see. Let's make this full. There we go. So let's just look. Like this looks pretty good. Obviously, the model is fairly basic. Well, he's got nice wrinkles here. Actually, actually pretty good.
Sometimes it's tricky to model like something simple like a box and make it like, because yeah, there you have like all the irregularities you would have in the real world, and all the kind of like
like wrinkles, and definitely the breakup is, and the folds are nice too, like how the one flap is going above the other one, so that's pretty well made.
And this actually helps a lot in lighting, because you get all the correct shadowing, and you get like all, it doesn't look too smooth and too clean, because there's always a problem with lighting that is like, you are looking for irregularities. You don't want like plain surfaces. You want some kind of breakup. And with it, when you have a good model where some small micro details modeled in it, it always helps from the get-go.
All right. So I think, it looks pretty convincing already. I would just make, like, especially like a close up like this, I would expect a tiny bit of depth of field, especially if you are focused on the text here. I'm not sure, like this seems to be very close to the camera, seems to be very close. I would expect maybe a bit of a depth of field here. It looks very sharp. That would be my first.
I was about to say the same, like a little bit of depth of field, but I think that's it.
Yeah. And then probably the white label here seems to be a bit too perfectly cut out. Like I would expect maybe that at some places it may be lifted a bit up from the packaging, so there's a bit more variation to the surface overall. And one thing is the text here, it also feels a bit too clean in terms of how it's printed. I would expect maybe you can
like
see
from fringing on the edges or something.
Exactly. Yeah. And even here you can see on the surface that it's very broken up, actually, the label, but there you can't see anything like that on the text, which is weird. But with saying all that, it still looks pretty good. Like I wouldn't say it's not looking good. Let's just go to the next one.
Okay, so this looks more like a cinematic scene of kind of
a game or
like a game cinematic or like game and maybe in-game stuff or
keep going.
Sorry, and, no, it's all good. And yeah, it's a little bit like some dude is pushing against the wall or leaning against the wall, and it will be interesting where this is coming from or where this inspiration is coming from. Is this like a piece that stands for himself, or is like a piece from a movie? Is overall it looks pretty good. There's some stuff in this areas on the kind of driver.
Yeah, sure.
Like these areas, it's a little bit like it looks like cables and stuff. It's hard to read a little bit. And what me strikes is like my focus gets automatically pulled to the stones here, because like they are like the
super bright,
the brightest part of the image. And this is especially something like coming from we work in animation. Like they always try, might be physically accurate that this light is hitting this rocks in a certain angle and it casts this kind of like bright situation on them. But like you want to like direct the viewer's focus. So it's like, I don't know, if the focus is about like this to pushing, I'll just tone the rocks down and you can do it like
gobos or whatever.
Yeah, gobos, or even like make them darker or do it in combo, whatever. And then it's like, if it's about the guy like having a breakdown and like just having a rest. But this is, technically it looks pretty good. It's just, I'm not quite sure what the scene is about.
Yeah, exactly. So Andrew is here, who's a pretty good modeler, and he's has a very successful Twitch stream as well. So he's asking who my guest is. So why don't you say quickly hello, Dennis?
Hey, I'm Dennis. I'm a senior lighting artist here at Sony Imageworks in Vancouver. Arvin and me worked together at ILM Vancouver, and we became good friends. He helped me a lot on some shows, and we kept going since then. And
pretty good.
I can post later some stuff in the chat, so you can check out my. I don't have Instagram or anything, but you can check out my Vimeo, or we have like a website coming up. I'm going to talk about later a little bit, and
Yeah, much LM Vancouver here. Like lots of people there, which is cool actually. But anyways, let's just continue here on the reel. So let's just check a bit more items here. So I think this is just a water fountain. Let's see if there's any more info to this. Wash basin. Type of stone thing just hit.
Archviz.
Yeah. But for me, it does not really look that photorealistic. Just there's like lots of things which are off. I feel like first of all, from a modeling standpoint, it looks again very very simple. Like no rock would look that simple in the surfaces, right? It's like it feels like it's very cut and straight. There's no breakup or displacement going on. Then the floor here, you wouldn't see a floor like that where you see the floor and the wall come together without some kind of connection there. So that is a bit weird. And I think this is the top part here is a mirror. It would be nice, I think, to see something that is like a mirror or reflecting something.
Even if you cheated or like
exactly.
The HDR. And what strikes me is like the backside of the thingy. Sorry, this is really dark. So if you think about like this is a white wall and this is like a pretty bright floor, and if you think like daylight comes in, if you look at it, like everybody has been in hotel bathrooms or whatever, like it gets a lot, it would get way more bounce light in it. Everything would be way more filled up.
I totally agree.
And I think this looks a little bit like the look was applied in post, and like they crunched the contrast a little
too
heavy.
And then in terms of shading and texture wise, I think like first what struck me the first was the copper shader here. It feels like it's just a simple shader and maybe some roughness adjustments, but that's it. Normally you would see lots of like corrosion and breakup on this, and I think that's totally missing here. And the same for the rock, the basin itself. Like it just feels like a simple texture on it. There's, as I said before, there's no displacement or any breakup. So definitely you want to go for photoreal. There's lots of things to consider in this one here. Anything to add?
No, sorry.
Let's just keep going. Okay.
That's what's really too good. That's some.
Scroll to see more. So this is a lot better.
Yeah, that's pretty cool. Yeah, this is exactly what you were talking about the copper, right? Here you got some kind of situation going on with some dirt or fingerprints or like some kind of. It looks aged. It looks like
used, right?
Yeah.
I'm not sure if this was really model. It might also just be a displacement map, but it still looks very good. Let's see if there is a visualization of various furniture models. I have models. So apparently he modeled them, which is great. That is a pretty great job, I would say. Like, especially like the wrinkles again, it looks really good. It would be nice, obviously, to see a bit more of the process, like maybe some diffuse maps or displacement maps, like just how it came together would be interesting to see. All right, that's
really cool.
Let's keep going. I'm not sure how many he has. Oh, yes, he has a...
Oh, there's a video.
Video, is this? Let's play it. 9 seconds. Okay.
Shadow of a tree.
Shadow of a tree. I think there's not much to say about it.
No, it's like, I think it's more like an R&D situation.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah,
I think it works.
I think that was it. Let's just go back on his main here, portfolio. I don't know.
Oh, yeah, like let's do like some like this. Let's just pick something.
Yeah,
like
this. I think picking makes more sense.
This is all. Should we do like the one with the cigarettes? I think this struck my eye in the first place.
Yeah, this is a strong piece.
There's a lot of more complexity in it.
Good call. So what did he do? I have a weird attraction to the communist mood and the oval design of things from that era. Okay.
Sounds good.
Yeah,
this is like, so he did all the modeling and all the basically everything, right?
I believe so, yeah.
Yeah. No, this is pretty good. It shows like complex stuff. There's some stuff there's like can improve a little bit, but
okay, go on.
For example, what struck me is the size of the texture of the what is called like the word board where everything is standing from.
Yeah,
it looks a little bit like the scale is a little bit off. It looks a little bit miniature.
Yeah.
But like a little bit too much. Also, like this area catches my attention a little bit too much. I think that the glass looks really awesome, like with this like old
bubbles.
With the bubbles, and there's like some lipstick. There's even like some kind of storytelling in it, like with lipstick, and the refraction works pretty good. There's like some dirt stains or whatever here. Then like this money looks good. Like this looks a little bit could be look more metallic. But overall, like it's like this is like small tweaks.
I think what catches my eye the most is the chromatic aberration on this, like the comp treatment. Like everything feels a bit like too much. Like you can see in the background here, you can see already the fringing of the red and green, and even in the foreground here on the wood, you can see it starting to get really green in the foreground. And I have to agree with the chat that the table looks a bit too plasticky. Like, I think the reason is it's just too glossy, and there's not enough texture detail, as Dennis said, that we just feel it almost feels like just a plastic coat of some kind of texture. I think the best in this picture is maybe the glass, I would say, at least the lower bottom of the glass with the liquid in, so that looks pretty good to me. Okay, let's see, different renders. I think it's just different crops. I wouldn't say it's just a different crop. And maybe one thing is that the money feels like cloth. It's not really like paper is actually very rigid, and I would expect if it would be like that, it should be a strong fold.
Should be like yeah. You're right. It's like especially yeah. Or maybe it looks like wet or whatever.
Yeah. All right. That was pretty cool.
That was pretty good stuff. Well, yeah. Like so, we go some. Here's a lot of arc twist. Maybe something. Maybe the car or something.
Car
something
is a bit
different.
Is there more?
It's a little tricky, right?
Yeah.
So this is not lovely.
What about this one?
Yeah, that's cool. It's like same theme. Like, yeah,
I think that's what he mentioned. Is that era or whatever? Yeah.
Oh, he's from Romania. Growing up, post communist Romania. Yeah.
Oh yeah. Okay.
All that's good stuff. Yeah, I think this is also pretty good. Like, these are the different crops of it, right?
Yeah, I would love to see like a clean render, like a render, and then what he did in comp, like because like it looks very compy, like very sharpened. The edges look very sharpened and everything.
Yeah, maybe it's. I think like what he's trying to do is maybe he's trying to get like this old film kind of thingy, because like to get like this sepia tone kind of, and maybe he pushes it too much. And but overall, like the material, it's like it looks pretty good. It's like. And like the damage here,
yeah,
and the bottle doesn't look bad, and
All right, let's see. Let's keep going. Thanks, Andrew, for hosting. That's really cool. Thank you very much, man. Much appreciated.
Thank you.
So let's check the kitchen here. And then I think we'll just skip to the next because we have so many to do. Let's see. Quick glance. Strong shadows here.
I feel like the lighting feels more natural than on, for example, like the sink. This is what like from the lighting situation, like this is what I would expect. It's very bright and very like, it's a white wall, it's white, bright floor. So there's a lot of like, you see the shadows here is they are kind of not so contrasty, and like the bounce, everything is, it looks like you imagine if you go to IKEA a little bit. I mean, in a good way.
Yeah.
Like, not in a bad. You get my point. It's like I'm trying to get.
You totally. I would say in terms of realism again, I'm just lacking a bit of that polish. Like maybe like everything again looks a bit too simple. Like I'm looking for details, and for photorealism, I think that's the key of it. Like you can see this paper back here in the back is just a box essentially, and the cabinets here look like marble almost. And yeah, the floor is also, I agree, very flat. So there's still lots of room of improvement here. But I like the overall feel of the lighting. It's pretty cool.
It's just about tweaking the materials a little bit.
I think so. What I find distracting is the HDRI you see through here. You can see it's stretched. It's very low quality. So if you want to do like a nice composition, maybe try to get a better backdrop here, which just is a bit more fitting. Like it feels like it's just the HDRI rendered or refracted. And you cannot open the cabinets. That's a good call. So maybe the handles are below or something, but I agree.
It's a design thing.
It's a design thing, yeah.
Talk to the designer. And then it's like, it's always like tricky. And CG is like good design or it's always like, okay, you got to think about how stuff might work. I mean, there's cabinets like this. In general, it's always like.
All right, so I think unless we want to just quickly still go through the other posts if we see something.
There's a lot of architecture.
That's better. That's actually.
I would say that's the strongest.
Yeah, I agree. Yeah. This is pretty much the strongest.
And now you see actually, okay, this is like play render kind of.
Yeah. I think it's pretty cool. One thing again is breakup. What you don't see on the chairs here, they are like perfectly just copied and moved over. So I would expect some randomization there.
Yeah, like I just wrote him.
Exactly. Yeah. Just minor things, but that just helps to sell it.
What do you mean, like on the wood planks on the floor? It's like I modeled back in the day a lot of like this stuff, and it helps. So I mean, it's just a plane here. But you can even like. Whether you do this placement or like modeling, and then you just put one thing like a little off, and it's like even here it's like on Ivan's floor, it's like it's never perfect, and there was always, if you look at it in the reflection, there's always some kind of like wobbling going on, and this is always what puts it off, and it adds, this is like a small adjustment, doesn't take that much time, and it's so much same as like you can do same thing on the tiling here on the wall. If you have this stuff, it's always cool, and you get like some kind of effect or some little bit of breakup, even if it's subtle, it helps a lot.
Yeah.
Kind of like this, he did it here in the model for these guys. It works pretty well. It gives away the that it's like cloth and stretching and bending.
And I agree with the chat again that the texture on the right wall it feels like too repetitive. It feels like a super small tile which just got repeated over and over. Sometimes you see that though. Sometimes you see prints on the wall which are just replicated. Like you can get those kind of patterns on the wall. But I agree that for this piece here, it looks maybe a bit too much. Let's just go check this. Oh, that's actually, is there a movie? Oh, this one has one.
Oh yeah, this one. Cool.
We'll see. Camera is a bit awkward. I don't know. It's
like weird on a gimbal or like what? Like
I think it's a Unity 5 interior walkthrough, so I guess he's just walking with the keyboards here.
Okay, and then it's a screen cap.
So I think he just baked everything down here. Let's see. Like these are the renders, I believe. It's not bad, honestly. I'm not sure if this will land your job in ArcViz. Like, you still need a bit more work on this. But, like, because if you compare it to, like, all these famous guys like Ronan Berkerman and all these guys who actually do this for a living, I think it's still a bit far off. It's like, it's definitely getting there. If this is his intention to work in ArcViz, it's not bad. But other posts work not so well.
Also, like a general thing is like, when like, especially with this ArcViz and still images, the issue with this with still images is always like, you look at it and like the ArcViz stuff is like printed on 6K or whatever. It's like super high res, and you look at it as a still image. Whereas like, oh, this would be visual effects and you have like a camera panel, like there's a foreground character doing some stuff. This will be all right, but it's like in film, it's like a different approach to detail and to be economic about stuff. Whereas like it's ArcViz stuff, it's like super polished. It's like super about showing off. It's like a catalog piece kind of situation. So it's like you spend more time looking at it. Whereas like the average visual effect shot, if it's a long shot, is like maybe 4 seconds. It's a long shot.
Exactly.
And so it's a different level of detail is required. Thank you.
No problem. All right. So I think, thank you, Andre, for your submission. It's definitely very good. Like it's definitely a great portfolio, and there's obviously always room to work on. But I would say maybe the best advice I could give you is maybe get rid of things which are not so strong in your reel, even if you worked on it like a few years ago, but always try to have your best pieces in your reel or in your portfolio. That's, I think, the most important thing you can take away from this. All right, so let's just keep going here. Let's go here so you can see our head. We still have Andre here. Let's remove him from the pics. And do you want to click?
Yeah, let's do it. Okay. I just click here. I like
you just head. Click on the head, yeah.
Can we make like a rabbit come out of it? No. We got Luis Paul Carvalho.
Carvalho.
Cool.
How many follows are you doing? Yeah, I'm not sure. We just... we will see. We want to go like 2 hours, Andrew, so we'll see. I'm not sure. So Luis Paulo, let's see if we find him in here and all my emails. There he is. So he sent a Vimeo link. That's great. So that's actually a proper showreel.
Copy this.
The modeling reel.
Ooh, it's a car.
Car 1:53. It's a good length, I would say.
Yeah. Already looked.
Let's just do this full. Do we want to see us that big? Maybe.
Although we look pretty good though.
Yeah, Andrew, so it's a modeling reel. So now it's your turn. So we can take a quick break here. Anyways, let's just play it.
Modeling texturing.
Do we need audio?
Oh, that's cool. I like this.
No audio. Right, let's
have a look.
Good edge loops.
Yeah, but this was what actually like I was talking about earlier. Okay, he says modeling texturing reel. It's pretty obvious what he's doing. He's showing wireframes so far.
That's funny.
Very, very interesting concept, yeah.
In terms of modeling, I would say, like, for me as a non-modeler, I would say it looks pretty clean, the mesh. Like, I love the detail on it, but again, that's just my observation. Like, if Andre would know better, I guess. And Andrew, I mean.
But in terms of presentation, it's really good. He shows like he goes from the big scale to the small scale. He shows the wireframes, turntables, and it's, yeah, like this stuff here. It's like, okay, even UVs, okay, this looks clean. This is like a breakup, but the parts he's doing it.
Oh, that's in a different
theme iron.
Looks very cartoony though. Like, if I would apply with this reel, I don't think I would show this. Maybe just the modeling side of things and not the whole animation.
Yeah, he's going for hard surface stuff. And,
yeah.
Yeah, it looks good. Looks pretty good.
Maybe a bit too round, like some of the corners, at least in the end of the guitar. Like this might be a bit too smooth. I think they are sharper. Or are they so smooth?
This is like the big question. I was like, also like he's pretty. You think like these screws and stuff, it looks pretty accurate.
Yeah. Yeah, so I think like if, oh, he actually did the look dev as well. So we can, I guess we can comment a bit on it. Like I have these I've got a different controller.
Now you get it, and now you're taking them apart.
No, I'm just saying that that's maybe a bit hard to see.
But yours is already dirty and much. Again, like I let me order it.
The thing is just that what I'm saying is that the controller, obviously that's PlayStation and Xbox, but I think the grips are similar in terms of the texture, and this, at least here what we can see, it looks very smooth.
I'm actually not sure. I think like the PlayStation ones, like the gray ones, they are smooth. They don't have like this.
Yeah, shut up then. Just keep going. We just play it again and we can talk over it and pause it if we need to. But definitely, as Dennis said, the presentation is pretty good, and this is what I would be looking in for a reel, like very slow pictures moving, showing all the details, and I think he's doing this in a really great way. And even the look dev is good. It's very clean, like it's as if it was just freshly out of the factory, like very clean, very polished. If I would go for realism again, I would add breakups and stuff like that.
But because he stated it's a modeling reel, it's not so. I think it's more to showcase this modeling that it's like working with the shade applied. So.
Yeah.
And I think
it's definitely great work from Lewis here. Yeah. It's not. There's not much to say. Obviously, it's just 2-3 pieces here. But I think this would be pretty good for definitely for VFX. Like this prop would hold up for sure. Maybe not for superhero close-ups, but I think it will definitely hold up in most VFX environments.
Yeah, it's
good. He's good.
Definitely would.
I wish I could mod like this. all right, I think that's good. Thank you very much, Luis, for your submission here. So that's the beauty of the videos. We just talk about it, and we can go a bit faster here. So let's just go to this scene here and click on remove him. Item removed. So let's just pick another one.
Who we got?
And who do we got?
Riham Kamal.
Come on, Riham. Looking for him. There he is.
Asset artist.
Okay.
We got another ArtStation.
ArtStation account. So, obviously, it would be best to, maybe I should specify it next time a bit better, that ideally we just get reels.
Looks pretty cool.
Like movies. Because ArtStation is always a bit, you have to click through all the posts. But, it's still working. Okay, let's just maybe get a quick overview. Let's how many posts was it for?
You can
just pick one.
See, no, we can do. I like the first one.
Okay, that's
pretty cool. And then later,
because it has
game asset made a contribution. The medieval pack.
Let's just make this full burst. There we go. Right, so now we have, I think,
he's a weapons and prop artist.
Weapons and prop artist.
He does weapons and props. That's
that's pretty specific.
Specified by that's good. I mean, that's good. Specific. And then to be fair, on the first gloom, it looks pretty good. But he has definitely all the irregularities and all the breakup and all the imperfections that we were talking about earlier.
Yeah, I definitely like this dented look. Like it really works.
It looks like it's crafted. Like I said, only thing would be interesting. Wireframe. Then the question of if this get out of ZBrush or.
Oh, there we see.
Oh, there, okay.
I think this looks like ZBrush.
Yeah.
And then raw modeling. I think this is a pretty
good. Oh, yeah, yeah, okay. I'm taking it back. It's like he did it pretty
It's good. All there.
It's all there.
So very simple model, like topology, but then obviously he sculpted like with all these nice little. Edges and breakups here, so this totally works. Okay, let's check the next piece. Oh, is that fancy hat.
Hard to read at this point. Like it's hard to the angle is a little bit like on. Okay, I'd say what strikes me like the texture is a little bit too big.
Yeah, it's like it's missing. Like it's lacking the cloth detail. You would almost expect you would see some fibers already, like little fur, like.
And you can see the edge a little bit.
Yeah, it's true. You can see the.
I think he said like it's game assets, so like.
Little poly.
Maybe it's a different.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a bit low poly, I think. It obviously would hold up if it's a bit further away, I guess. Let's see. Oh, yeah, I'm clicking.
Let's check the gun.
MPX. Oh, yeah. Submachine gun.
That's a...
It's lots of glow, like, for the presentation, maybe it's a bit much.
Yeah, texture detail looks good. Texture. Turn on it.
It's a fingerprint.
It's a big finger.
It's a very big finger, yeah.
You're like a big guy. You're a big gaming guy.
Definitely. Know. One thing I noticed is that the what's it called? The
scope?
The scope, yeah. The
sniper scope.
This, you would not see anything through it, right? That's one thing I would say is that it's normally like a camera lens. It should be super clean, like that you actually, when you look through it, that you actually see your target.
Yeah.
And if that's the case, you would not see much, I believe. Again, LP game asset, low poly game asset. So I guess it's just baked down maps, like high quality displacement maps, and then applied on the low poly model. I'm really liking the detail.
Yeah, like I would say, like for a game, do we have like this kind of detail? Do we need this kind of detail? But it looks like it is pretty. Even if you look at the what is it called, like the bullets, the magazine.
The magazine here.
It's like with the it's like the see-through? Translucent plastic or whatever. Pretty.
Definitely, yeah. It's definitely funky.
Pretty awesome, yeah. Like, is it a real gun? Do you guys know it, or is it like something he designed as well, or like?
I think it's a real gun. Like, you could get this. I think it said the type here, 6-hour-ing. Blah, blah, blah.
Okay.
Obviously, we are not in the States, so I'm not sure about.
We're not like guns. That. We're not that. We're not into guns. Like, we don't have much.
And the layout. So yeah, I think this is pretty good. Definitely a great asset for a game. Like, I would love to see games with this kind of quality. Maybe let's go. Let's just pick this up. So this is a pilot bag. I guess low poly as well. Yeah, I did. I think the first thing I notice is the texture is too blurry, too low quality, and I think the pattern is too large as well.
It looks a little bit like,
yes,
but the model is good, like, but it's just, I think, like, yeah, the texture,
it's more a simple asset, I would say. It still looks okay, like, definitely it's definitely a prop for a game, so I think it's not bad. Low poly, yeah. All right, so thank you, Riam, for your submission. And I think we should just keep going here. And let's see who our next lucky pick is. So, oh, I didn't remove him. Dang it. Okay, so we need to remember that.
Yeah.
We don't pick it. All right, let's do it.
Florian Vina.
Sometimes you are too far away.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Okay, thank you. Oh, I think I know. Okay, let me just do that quickly. My gate here, let's just do... Oh. I'm just fixing the gate here. Just scream, yeah.
Okay!
Yeah. Okay. Now everyone is awake. Filters. So I just want to disable the noise gate. So now I think he should be there.
Oh, I was muted the whole time. Oh.
All right, so Florian, he's definitely German, so let's see if we have him in the emails here. Hallo Florian, vielen Dank für deine Submission. okay, let's find him. Let's see, Florian, where he is. I hope he's in the chat. Say hello if you are.
Sag was, Florian.
There he is. No, it's not him. Dang it, another Florian. Okay, I think they can hear you now, Dennis.
Okay, I better be quiet.
There he is, now I found him. Review. So he sent an art station, Kirk 89. All right, here we go.
I don't even have the art station is big, right?
Art station is pretty big, yeah. Oh, he's got lots of stuff.
Okay, ooh. This is gonna be, let's go strategically. Let's pick the best from the thumbnail, like the maybe two or three different things.
It's hard pickings.
Yeah, it is. So he looks like he's like a modeling guy, like modeling.
characters and environment.
Environment, okay.
And scanning. Does he have a bit about him? Let's see if there's an resume.
I spent it scanning for modeling. Oh, hi, I am. Stuttgart. Maybe like this.
Sorry, I clicked already.
Okay, like.
Which one?
Oh, let me. Oh, can you go over? So it's a basement 3D scan. Also, he's actually into scanning. If he does, and I'm not too interested in characters right now. Let's do the church scan. It's maybe interesting.
This one?
Yeah.
I'm back. Kyosha.
Okay, there's no movies. So it's like, just figuring out what he did. So he scanned this and then cleaned it up, or?
That's been too full, actually. Sorry. So it looks like he's just taking tons of pictures, do some photogrammetry and reprojecting them. There's some kind of movie.
Ooh.
Very fisheye. Yeah, I think that's what it is. So he just captures the textures essentially and projects them back on. I would not say that this is a pretty difficult thing to do. Like, I can go out now, take my camera and take pictures, right?
It's tedious though, right?
It's tedious, but it's not that you do it manually. Obviously, you take the pictures manually, but then it's just like you just put it into the software and it just does it for you. And I'm not sure if this is like if you show this and if you want to apply for a job and you show this stuff, I don't think they would say, oh, this is great work what you did here.
And it's already very specific. I don't even know what the job would be for this. It's very specified, I think. In games or stuff, they do stuff like this and they clean it up a lot. And
they extract displacement maps for this and project it back on. That's for sure, yeah. Let's maybe check out the sculpt here. Let's just give some feedback on this.
Oh, it's the guy from... Is it the guy from I think Better Call Saul?
Better Call Saul and Breaking Bad, right?
Yeah. I like this guy.
I think it's supposed to be him, but it's far off.
I mean, the thing is, I like this series a lot, so it struck my eye. But yeah, it's not... If it's supposed to be the dude...
That's so serious.
And maybe it's not the dude. And then we're,
if it's not the dude...
Then we're kind of like... That would be not good.
Let's see. I'm not sure what his name is, though.
I forgot his name. Like, is a cop.
There he is.
Yeah.
What's his name? Jonathan Banks. No, let's just move him over. So both of us were thinking that that it's him. But then again, we're not so sure. It could be. It could not be. Maybe it's not him. Like, I don't know. But yeah, I think it's just lacking, like, in terms of proportions. It's lacking quite a few things, like, for a photorealistic thing. If this is just a scan, which this is, I think this is supposed to be a sculpting thing. Lex Anatomy, exactly. And yeah,
it's so soft. It feels very, very soft. There's like the like this has more wrinkled, like, gosh, it's hard to put the finger on it. Something feels
a bit off. I would say, like, obviously look at references and always work off of references. And I think this is just not really there yet. It needs lots of more work, lots of repetition and iterations, I think. And it's a very similar thing to this one. I'm just clicking.
You're
not
too excited.
Yeah, it's hard to. I think as a student, it's okay, but you definitely need way more work and look lots of tutorials on how to do digital humans. And it's actually himself, so don't be too harsh.
No. I'm not harsh. The thing is, like, what I'm also like, I'm seeing a lot of like students read and they put this digital human sculpt on it, and I'm always wondering where's like. Where's the job later for this, like, this digital human sculpting? Because, like, if you have like a CGW, you might basically start off like a scan or something. And it's just like we worked on The Irishman, and I think there were like two modelers or something involved, and then we had like the scan as a base, and then they went from there. But and then we, in the end, we just use parts. So if you go like one shot further, like the Al Pacino one works pretty good. Like this one works pretty good. So it's like, yeah, what we were kind of drive, like, sure. What we like, I think like, they use parts of the forehead. We kept the eyes, like the original eyes. We kept the mouth. And then I think this part here is CG and some is blended. And then it's kind of like a comp situation too. And Yeah, it's like digital humans is all like, it's still tricky, and it's really hard to do.
Yeah, and I just think that it's Florian still has to go a long way to nail it. Like, it definitely, it's a great start, but obviously there's still lots of work to be done. So I think let's just continue here. Let's just make switch the scenes here, and let's pick another one. Yeah, shall we? So let's see who we're picking. Abhishek Panchal. Let's
see what we got.
See what we got. So let's see if we find him. And again, if you're in the chat, please say hello. I think he sent us a YouTube link.
Is it real? That's good. We see what we got. Oh, lighting, it looked real.
Okay, that's our specialty.
Now we're gonna destroy you. No, just kidding. No, also, like, everything we say is like from a, like, everything we say is good. Is like, there's nothing where we say, oh, this is like, look for another profession or something. It's like always like there's some stuff that works better. There's stuff that doesn't work as good. And there's always like, even we always improving, and always is always something to learn.
Yeah.
And this is such a, like, also the notes we're giving, like, some stuff you might not agree with, but it's always like when you work a little bit in this industry, like, most of the notes you get is always, they're always similar. It's about like, oh, break up surfaces is about,
yeah, always break up. Yeah, that's like the main thing.
It's like the main thing. Then it's like about like creating depth, and it's about creating a shape, and guiding the eye. And so what we like telling you, it will be probably experiencing later on in your career. And just to give you a little bit of an idea.
It's essentially when we sit in dailies with the VFX soups, and essentially that is what we get, like when we present our shots, this is a similar feedback, I think. Let's see. Andrew's taking off. Thank you very much, Andrew, for showing and hosting, actually.
Thank you so much.
More rim. Yeah, more rim. That's true. Okay, let's just play this one back here and see what we get. So full screen. And let's do play. Do we want audio? No, we don't care for audio. That's
fine. Environment lighting. Oh, that's good.
Let's see.
It's also the modeling.
So lighting, I looked at. Oh, I'm missing scattering on the end. Did you light footage? All right. Which one is it replacing?
The right one. This is the north. No, yes, the north.
Oh, we'll see.
See.
Ah, that was right. Oh, yeah, just that one. Okay.
That's actually pretty cool. Yeah. You can see it on the spec mode. What's this? What's this? Damn, the motorcycle.
Oh, I think the audio is actually playing. Oh, that's out of proportion. Like, she looks tiny.
She's just small.
Well, she's very small. Oh, that is the railing. Well, it's a bit weird though. This looks just out of proportion, right? Oh no.
Yeah, it looks weird. Maybe it's part of the story. But that's okay. Ooh. What is this? Like,
must be like from a game or something. I don't know.
He's supposed to be like this clay or this.
Yeah. Lighting show reel. Okay. Mental array. Interesting.
Okay. Is he listening? Or?
I think he said hello. If this is some Abby 14337, is that you? I think I would guess it's him.
Okay.
Yeah, he says hello.
Hello, so. Abby. How are you doing?
Let's just mute it and just keep playing it.
So I thought like the strongest shots were like the integration shots.
Yeah.
Like the one with the like little statue and the,
where is it?
Like I like this one too. This is pretty, I didn't, in the first glimpse I wasn't sure what's happening, so that's good.
Oh, this one. Yeah.
Yeah, I think this was like, this is a good, this is really, really strong because like you can, like me and Abby, we were both looking, okay, which one is the fake one? And that's really good. You make here, it looks.
Yeah. Well, the car, you could see that the car is not really in here properly. Like it definitely like, also scale, I think is off again, right? It looks way too small, I think, for the road. Normally, like a car is like, well, why not?
Is it like a two-lane road? Is like one lane?
Sure.
I don't know. If they look, he's going maybe two cars okay. For things like
that might be okay.
Might be alright. Like the motorcycle, can you do the motorcycle?
Yeah, I can actually do this too.
Here. I think like the motorcycle looks.
No, I messed it up again. There we go.
I think it looks alright. I think we did worse motorcycles at ILF.
I'm thinking it's okay. Like I think the tracking on the integration work is good. But I would say like in terms of look dev, it's not really matching yet. Like it doesn't feel like the shadow feels very, like very contrasty here at the bottom. And
yeah,
I think like in terms of look dev, there's, yeah, it's, I think just too crunchy. It's very diffuse environment, but this is all super crunchy.
It looks like something's working with the guys inside. Is it like just a plane?
It looks like a refracted plane.
Or like some stuff. And then it's like, yeah, the shadow is definitely, yeah. And it's like the glass is not accurate. I mean, yeah. It kind of like, it doesn't bother me that much in the moment, but it's like, yeah, like this is not like you were supposed to see through this. Then the shadow definitely is too, it's really crunched. And then this feels a little bit like the color is off. And I mean, car paint is kind of a tough material.
Yeah.
I think the motorcycle is better than the car.
Yeah. I think it just because it's not so strong in the picture. Maybe.
Yeah, maybe.
And yeah, the integration is good, I think. The rest is played. Yeah, as people in chat say, it's played. And then he just added the elements here. And I think, as Dennis said, like, I think this one here is the strongest integration. Like, I was expecting, like, this one here to be the replacement, but it's actually the one on the far right. And now that I know it, it's obvious. It's just, it's not matching the same color patterns. The label is not the same. But it's still, in terms of matching, it's pretty good. And the tracking is good as well.
Yeah, like, and it's like this stuff from previous where we said, like, oh, for visual effects, like, you don't focus that much. Like, okay, in a shot like this, they might say, okay, this is fine. We're good. Just they comp it and it's fine. But it's like, yeah, there's always room for improvement. If you say, oh, you want to match it and you want to get like notes on it to match it perfectly, it's like, okay, go like, okay, we got like this. You pick this value. You want to, like, you know, it's like you compare it and it's like, oh, like the reflection is like, even if can we stop there?
Record? I can pause it. Sorry. Yeah.
Like if you look, oh, you got like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 pings. You got
there's just one.
Three pings. Then it's like you look at the dark side, like, and it's like this looks lifted. Here you can see a little bit of edge. It's kind of cut out.
Yeah.
And then also like here you can see some kind of patina, like some kind of like diffuse dirt situation on the pen. And this is perfectly,
yeah,
perfectly straight. And
yeah,
I mean, it's always stuff, but for the shot, it works. I mean, it's like you can do like even the complete color correction, and yeah,
I think also what you can see in the reflection as well, like it's definitely a different material here. You can see that the plate ones are very contrasty, but then if the CG one is added, it just feels very, very like gamut up or something. It looks definitely weird.
Yeah. And you can even like, the good thing is that he is the shadow and there's the shadow. It's a little bit off. You can like compare these things.
Yeah. And then for the beginning ones, like we, as you can see, we skip them because like, I just don't feel this should be your real opener. Like, this looks very, very CG and like a game from, I don't know, early 2000s or something, like with these lens flares and then you get this super huge grass on the foreground. Like it just feels totally out of proportion in my opinion.
Yeah. The other stuff is way stronger.
Yeah. Yeah. So if you want to apply for lighting look dev, I would definitely take these ones out or at least not have them as your first shot. This one here is a bit better, I would say, but also not a strong, like a very strong piece.
Yeah, it's like it looks like it's not run with a physically accurate render, and it looks done. It is done with something, I don't know, like sort of a game engine, like an old game engine or whatever. Whereas the other stuff with the car and the integrations is
And yeah, as I said, this one, like, even though there's green screen and she's like touching that little bar here, I just think it looks off in proportion. Like it's just weird. Like it just feels totally off. And I can't really say, it's just scale. Like the lamps are too small down, like the door. Like if I would think that if a person would walk in here, I would just think that she's maybe like 50 centimeters high or something like that. Or that's what I'm thinking. And she's missing shadow. Yeah, thank you very much. And there was also a question like how I feel about still images in showreels. I think if they are not really static and if there's like maybe some crop ins or like little zooms, it's okay. But obviously you want to judge the specular highlights. So it's still better to have it.
The thing is also like for companies, like if you just present, if this is your show, it's like, yeah, if like this one or two still image is fine, but it's also like, you never know what he did. Like if this is created in 3D or like there's people that paint stuff in Photoshop that looks photoreal and you can easily
that's true, right?
That's true. And it's like, but as soon as you pan the camera, it's like, okay, yeah. Like then it's breaking apart or this is holding up. This is how you can judge the work, right?
Yeah. Yeah, I agree. So it's, as Dennis said, it's always better to have moving pictures for sure. All right, let's keep going here. Thank you, Abhishek, for your submission here. So let's just switch over here. Okay, let's just remove him. All right, so who will be the next reel? Alexandre Mary or Myrie. Oh, let's see. Alexander, it sounds French.
Maybe, yeah.
Do you see him in the emails?
Maybe your setup is broken. Maybe it's a different.
Where did they get this name? Like, let's see.
It doesn't exist. Is it like alphabetical?
No, that's not.
You go down. It was Big Andre. What is it? Mary.
Not sure why. That's unfortunate if he's not here. That's weird. Where does his name come from? I'm Belgian. Hey, Mary. Got some water. do you mind sending your stuff, Alexandre? I don't see your email anymore. Like, he's in the chat, which is great. So he can just, please post the link here. That would be amazing. But somehow we picked your name, so you must be somewhere. But
must be somewhere.
Permission. Oh, yeah. Distorted, thank you very much for modding here. You are the missing link. Oh no. Okay, we got it. Thanks. All right. All right, so we've got five pieces. Oh, I think that's what it was. I think, yeah, anyways. All right, so let's see.
ArtStation game.
ArtStation. No, we have got one movie here. Let's just bring that up. Start with the movie. There you go. Full screen.
Boom.
So what is this? UE4, Unreal 4 video game, End of Studies project.
Okay, this done Unreal.
Probably 2 years ago, so this might be a bit old. Let's just first play it then. Do we have audio on? No, it's off. It's
play.
Hot egal. I should stop talking. So I'm sure this would be then real time, right? So this is like a real time camera movie.
Yeah, this is game trailer, I think. Oh yeah, this game captures. Oh, this is a game. Basically.
Yeah, I think so.
Well, it looks pretty cool. I mean, it's like,
I like the indirect lighting, like all the bounce colors, like that looks really nice.
It's very contrasty and aggressive.
It's a bit hard sometimes to see
where the dude is. I wasn't going to say it because there's so much
stuff. But I would play it, I think.
Yeah, like, that looks cool. And especially with this game stuff, it's crazy.
Ultra laser.
Laser.
Well, it's a cool trailer for sure. Like, yeah. I think this is something, if I would see the trailer on at the App Store or something, I think I would load it and at least give it a go. Let's see about the other pieces here. I'm not sure exactly. Let's go about. Maybe there's a bit more. Full-time contract, modeling, hard surface modeling, PBR texture, look dev, and rigging.
Okay, so it's like more.
And he's got a little bit of a breakdown, texture artist, freelancer. Okay. Game looking good. Yeah, I agree. Student, really. Yeah, pretty cool. Very good work, Alex. Like, the game trailer was pretty good. All right, so I guess four pieces. We can just fairly quickly go through here. Another old retro room here. We had that before.
It was similar to the guy from, what was his name? From Romania?
Romania, yeah.
It's like similar. Thing might be coincidence.
Yeah, probably. That was obviously the fuse one. I think it's very hard to see perspective here. It feels like you have like a 200 mil lens on it. So everything is very compressed.
Like an orthographic render.
Yeah, orthographic. Yeah. So I think what would help is obviously not have it fully front on. I'm missing perspective definitely. So different kind of focal length would be helping. In terms of look dev, it feels a bit flat, I think.
Yeah, it only looks. It looks like even something like a viewport
capture.
Yeah, I don't know. Like if this is there's light. It's kind of. I don't like. I see this. I don't really know what he wants to show
to
me.
Show, yeah.
Yeah. And it's like the model. Like here's like this small like tiny like stuff. There's detail. It's not bad. And it's just like you can present it better. Like if you want to, I don't know. If you want to show up the TV, do it
better angles.
Yeah, better angles. And I don't know. It's like frame is it 16:9? Is it like it's weird.
Yeah. And even like I would expect maybe more reflections on the monitor. Like, and there's definitely no shaping. It just feels like a flat thing. I think they were curved. Like
they're really curved.
They're
curved,
right?
So they catch some kind of spectrum. And then it's like they have glass and inside is a layer with like this like small like diode.
This RGB components, I think.
Yeah,
right?
Then it's like it's like some complexity to old like Röhrenfernseher.
And what I notice here, like there's a super strong light from the right, but then there's no shadow, nothing here. So that's definitely something which is a bit weird. Like at the shadow, there's no bounce light. So let's just go to the next one. Okay. So this is a product shoot, I guess, for this ceramic bowl. I think the first thing which captures my eye is the floor or the wood paneling. It's like too lacking detail. It's too big, I think. It like the corners here, like everything feels blurred and a bit smooth, I think.
Yeah, overall it works way better than the other shot.
That's for sure. Yeah, even the depth of field works nice. You can see what I'm talking about here. Like you get this nice detail on the bowl, which is super sharp lines, and you could actually would think about touching it, you would feel the surface like would be broken up and detailed.
Yeah.
But then on the wood itself, it feels like it's super smooth. Like that's maybe something which you can work on. But it's so good.
Yeah, it's good. It's just And I always like when it's the same like with we want to direct the focus. If this is about the bolts, also like you say like it's a thing. But it feels very busy here and like also very busy here. So yeah, you can do like a wood that's maybe like or like simplify it. Like don't I don't push. What did I do?
Oh, what did you do, Dennis?
Oh, okay.
I don't touch anymore. There we go.
Overall, I think this is some tweak. This is not bad. It's cool.
And I think maybe one thing to add is if you want to direct your eye to the focal point here, I would maybe add a gradient or like a vignette to just darken the top here. So this is very bright and I just don't want to look at the blurry stuff at the top here. All right, let's keep going. So next up is a coffee box. Does he have a title for this? Petit beurre café.
I think it means small coffee box or something.
Okay.
So I think it's there's some stuff going on. I think like overall it's cool. You apply all the aging and like the details. What first struck me is like, I don't want to eat these cookies. There's nothing like that, but it's just like, they look very perfect.
Yeah.
They look very perfect.
Like manufactured. Yeah.
Like they look like toys, like kids cookies, like made of plastic, like not like, you know, with the dough and stuff. And then like the definitely like here, the texture detail, it's all over the place. And it's like,
looks
like
artifacting or something.
And it looks like he's, I don't know if it's stretching, whatever.
Yeah.
And same, it's like, you want to present these box cookies, like, I don't want to look here simplified, even put like a piece of cloth, whatever, like nice and simplify this area. Then yeah, this is also, it's too, it's just,
it's like tar almost, yeah, right? It's
perfect.
Like charcoal.
The cup is all right. You can add like a little bit, even like here, you can do a little bit more. If it's ceramic, even you can go in and what I like.
Scatter.
Yeah. Or like, even like to take the modeling and just make it a little bit, like.
Oh, add some bump more?
No, like distort it. Just like take the edges and make it like, because it's ceramic and it doesn't have to be perfect. It helps just a tiny bit.
I totally agree. Like, at least in terms of the breakup, for sure.
Yeah.
Let me just
Let me just handle
it. Obviously, we don't want to look at horses, but let's just do coffee.
Now we do. We're getting really deep here.
Really deep, and I think which I notice is that it's super thin ceramic or porcelain, and I would expect the light coming through. Like, if you would look at porcelain, it's very scattery.
Like.
Maybe not this one.
not this one.
You can see it maybe here, which you can see it's getting definitely lighter on the back sides here. Let's see if we have a better one. And as someone said, there needs to be bubbles. The rough side is unsplashed, which is pretty amazing.
But I can go back to this one. That's what I'm saying. For example, the handle here is like, yeah, it is kind of, but it's a little bit like, there's some kind of organic to it. It's not perfectly, and there's some kind of like, it's not completely like, it's not like a nerves thing that you like vector shape. And I mean, here's even like a lot of
bump, right?
Bump, yeah. But that's.
I'm just quick here. This, yeah, you can even see here that it's not as crunchy. Like, this just feels very black or dark here on the shadow side. And if you have like the strong light source, you can see that even on the shadow side, there's so much light coming through that material. So definitely stuff to work on. At least on the cookies need definitely work. The coffee itself, the mug itself, and for sure the wood here just doesn't work. And it has weird artifacts. It's just, yeah. Definitely lots of room to improve.
It's like a day or two of work and then you can make it happen. But it's just like, yeah, it's like obvious stuff and yeah, you get there.
Okay, I'll just skip this. Okay, I think we're through.
That's it.
Let's see. Thank you, Alex, for your submission. And I hope we were not too harsh on it. It's just critical feedback and it should just help you, right? Thank you very much.
It's good stuff. Like I said, it's like, yeah, you spend a day at work and it's like, yeah, you want to make sure if you show stuff, that you knock him out with the first punch. That is like, it looks, and if you're not sure about it, then ask somebody and keep up the great work. Looks cool.
Right, let's keep going here. Clicked on the wrong one.
The hat.
You wanna do the hat?
Let me do that.
Let's just click remove first.
Okay.
And then,
push the button.
Yeah. And whoop. Yeah.
Do it. Oh, I have to put it in. Okay. It's not that easy.
It's not that easy.
Abdul Rahman.
We had him, right? No?
No, we had...
I think... Okay, maybe not.
No, we didn't have him.
Okay,
we had... Sorry, so many people.
We need to pick up the pace as well. We will try to do a bit faster now. We're taking way too much time here. And first of all, we need to find him and... Let's see. There.
That is number three. Model texture artist based Singapore. There's a website.
Oh, there's a website. That's cool. Okay. Oh, I think I've seen this already. All right. So he's got four pieces. And what did he say? Is he a
model and texture?
Model artist. Texture based in Singapore. Yep. He worked on the commercial side. But he wants to be accepted in the film industry.
Okay.
I think that's his self-portrait, work in progress.
Let's start with the violin.
Violin. Okay, we just need to pick it up a bit. So he's in the chat as well. So thank you very much for your submissions here.
Hey man, how you doing?
So it's always great to start with references.
Yeah, I was about to say that. Yeah. You did your research. That's awesome. And
It shows.
Yeah, that's like all this stuff. Like, okay, you have a reference. There's always something we should say. It's like, yeah, work with reference. There's nothing wrong about working. Some people say, oh, you cheated. You work with reference. No, it's like, this is what you do. And you avoid all the comments about, oh, this doesn't look like this. And when there's an argument, you show the reference. They say, okay.
Yeah, exactly.
Change it anyway.
I want it.
I want it different.
So I'm not sure. Let me check the ref quickly again. It's a bit hard to see any. Oh, here you can see.
No.
I was just looking at the spec and just looking at it for the first time, like the rotating one, the turntable, it feels a bit too rough. I would expect maybe a bit more shine on it and a bit more bump.
Maybe a little bit more breakup, you mean?
Yeah, just that the specs, like here, it just feels overall very soft in the roughness.
But overall, it feels like it looks pretty good. This is the first thing I would say. It's like, this is like super strong, and this is like, okay,
I agree. And that's, yeah, a few people say that too. I think it's definitely a great one. It's definitely
if you work cool. Like, for example, at ILM, like in the S, this would be like a great first pass, and then they would go on, and then it's like at some point, it's just like, yeah, what they want, but it's like, I think you got look the variation in like the back,
Well, it's definitely mirrored, which is a bit weird. And
But he has. But this stuff is different.
No, I just mean the seam there. You can see the UV seam. I'm not sure if that is intentional.
I think it might be intentional actually, because it's not lining up here. I don't know. It's like, this would be also like something from the maybe they build it like it, or maybe not. If
let's see if it's here.
Okay. The backside.
We don't see the backside.
Yeah,
it's only good. Let's keep going here. Okay, he said we should not comment on the orc.
Okay,
we will not
skip the orc.
Okay, let's check the grid. What is it?
Woman.
It looks like the one from here. What was it? The one NPC the crazy digital female.
Blade Runner.
Blade Runner.
Yeah. Really? No.
Doesn't look like her.
No.
Okay. No. He says no. Dennis says no. Play it. Go on. Not her. No, okay. People say it's not her.
Yeah, I think it's. I think I have the same shirt actually.
That's the
best. Yeah, Martin brought it for me from Hawaii.
Okay.
I think the hair looks good. It's like this, like this.
Yeah,
this,
the groom is
this,
pretty good.
This micro detail. Then I think the expression is good. There's something about the skin that looks a little bit too soft, right?
Yeah, and I also like, let's just bring it back up here. It feels like, oh, come on. Is it the peach fuzz? Like something is just a bit distracting in the it's the peach fuzz. She has got super long hair on the nose, and you don't really have that. If you have peach fuzz on the hair.
Yeah, but mostly on the cheeks.
It's cheeks in here, but it's just like this is just super long hair. And then there's like it's a very strong bump map. Like you can see it here. I can't skip like single frames, unfortunately.
But we like to be honest, like this has been the best digital we've seen. Human we saw today. And it's, I would say like this would work for like like something like Blur, like a cinematic, high-end cinematic studio.
Yeah,
it's pretty good. Like the thing is, like with Digital Human, as we said before, it's one of the hardest things to do. And even like ILM, where they are struggling with it, and they have like hundreds of people working on it.
Yeah, I think maybe one thing is, I'm not sure about the iris size. It might be a bit large.
Maybe she did some
some surgery.
So substances, not like.
It's definitely a good, I would say there's still lots of room of improvement. I think the scatter is a bit too strong, especially on the nose and on the lips. This one looks actually pretty good.
It looks, I think, because the other hand is a strong light and it's kind of like the subsurface a little off.
Yeah.
And
this feels actually a lot better than the other ones, which is weird. Like this one looks very like smooth and scary.
Yeah, and because the light is so bright and it's like the scatter is too much and the other soft and so wouldn't affect it that much. I don't know.
Yeah. It's definitely a good first pass for sure, or a good pass.
And then yeah, considering that he did everything, it's pretty good. Yeah. But yeah, like I said, like Digital Humans is like to show it in your show is always like, yeah. Basically you can't just there will be nobody says oh this looks perfect. It's yeah. It's one of the hardest things to do, and sometimes you do yourself a favor with this.
Oh, is that Harris? One thing I would say is show the reference as well. Like especially if you want to say okay, this is like trying to match someone. I think he did all aspects, so yeah, I would probably say he sculpted it. I think the strongest one here is the groom, which looks very good, very natural. Yeah. All right, let's keep going. We said we want to be faster.
Yeah,
so let's just do his self portray.
Yeah, we can skip it.
There's no ref, so we can't compare it, right?
Yeah.
And I'm not sure why it's so dark. Did I do anything weird?
No, look, he's bright on the diffuse.
Like, it feels very dark, like very faded. So it's a bit hard to judge. That's just the diffuse map. So we just skip those two, I think. Definitely two strong pieces here.
Like, if you want to just my advice, if you want to break into film, it's like, okay, you won't. The thing is that if you work at a big studio, you most of the time you won't work. You rather work as a creature modeler or where we were doing like Digital Humans or any kind of creatures, or you work as a asset or hard surface or whatever modeler. Oh. And I think it's way easier at this point to get into this prop situation and to get like into prop modeling.
Yeah.
And then you do just a little bit more pieces like this. And then once you're there, you can start from there. And it's like the thing what I was saying is like even at ILM we had like I think one or two senior modelers working on the whole Irishman movie, and it's like it's very, very, very hard to get with this stuff. It's like, oh, we need always people that do props, and then when you're there and they say, oh, you got potential for kick, then but you have a get-go, right? And it's always like this industry, how you get in and then what you make of it. But yeah, great work.
Yeah. Okay, let's keep going here. So pick a new guy. Let's see. Item removed. And we are getting Emilou.
Who? Emilou. Okay.
Who? Emilou.
Emilou. Not Marilou.
Not Marilou. Okay. There. She, I guess she...
Oh, it's
a German. German. I would... Yeah.
She's doing internship. Blah, 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 blah.
Okay, let's. So she's got a rigging reel and a main reel. So let's just do the main.
Yeah.
Okay, integration work. Show reel for modeling, texturing, and comp.
Cool.
4 months ago, so that's fairly recent. So full screen, let's go full screen over here. And mute it. You can see like that's one thing. You don't need to have audio, or you don't need like if you do your show reels, you don't need to pay crazy amount of attention on editing it to the sound. Like most reviews like we do now, we just mute it, and even at bigger companies, I'm pretty sure they don't listen to all the audio. But anyways, let's keep playing here and then we talk about it after it. So rigging, modeling, and comp. Oh, she did actually everything.
Yeah. I think this is
except the eyes, the rest is pretty good.
Yeah, the eyes. And...
It looks, yeah, well.
Yeah, I like the one.
It's okay. Yeah, it's, I guess that's what it's supposed to be. Oh, that's not so good.
I mean, it's not bad. It's just like, what do you like the style? It's like...
It's just, I think the whole texture thing, it's like, it feels a bit too... like, it's not a smooth surface. It feels like very bent and it's not, yeah, I don't know.
Oh, it's cool. It's good. The lighting could be.
It's very wet floor.
Yeah. Oh, I like the first one the best.
Yeah, I agree. Oh, this one looks cool.
That's cute. It's cute. Yeah. It's like. Oh, that's actually pretty. That's pretty cool.
That's pretty good.
Oh, this is pretty fucking hard to do.
It is.
What he has, like, he's not even like an octopus. He's like a double octopus kind of thingy. Like.
This is the strongest piece for sure. This should be in the front.
Yeah, like this guy and then the other guy, then kill the...
Let's just redo it. Watch it again.
No, this is like also like this is... is it water? Is it CG? Probably, right? Yeah, it looks like...
I'm not sure.
And I like if you look...
Yeah, I know it is. There you go.
I mean, that's, look, this is like a pretty, pretty, like, can we stop on the final? This is a pretty impressive piece. It's like the animation is, yeah, is all right. It doesn't organic, burn it up, yeah. But this can be easily like some kind of commercial. Like, this is like,
it could be. Yeah, I agree.
And it's like, yeah, of course, there's more, you can do the ice, but it's like everything we said before is like, oh, there's like, actually like this rubber material. It feels very rubbery. Yeah. And it, like, there's the right amount of like sculpting and detail.
Yeah.
The shading is, of course, you can add like some translucency here, but
it would help.
Yeah, you know, but the water sells for water, and it's pretty impressive generalist work, and it's pretty cool. And what I also like, it shows like, I don't know if she did, oh, she did the concept, right?
It's like, yeah,
so she designed the character, so it's something like where it's like, yeah, it's something like, oh, it's kind of a cute character. You showed kind of your creative side, so this is a really good. And it has some appeal to it. Like,
yeah, I agree. One thing on comp side is I think it's a bit too noisy, and I think the chromatic aberration is again too strong.
Yeah.
Like this, the green here, the green fringe, like this is a bit much.
I was assuming it to be like a small one, like an action figure kind of situation.
Okay.
Because like this.
Oh, I see.
But I don't know. Like this is, yeah, but what I was getting from the thing.
Yeah.
I don't know, but it's model so is good. Like, yeah,
this is good. This works nice.
Stuff on the eyes. There's even some translucent. Like this is, yeah. It's like also, okay, it's Lucy Liu. It's like, I thought it was Lucy Liu. Okay. And it's all right, but then it's also like, I don't know, like, I see the first thing is like, okay, I like it. I would hire you. We have a commercial job. Yeah. Boom, boom, boom. I see this. And I was like,
I agree. Exactly.
It is not bad. And it's like, but it's like, also like when you put stuff together, it's like there's quality bar jumps, like differences between your projects. Make sure you got the strongest project in the front.
Yeah.
I agree. And if you just have these two projects, like this dude with the swimming dude and the other one, it's like, okay, yeah.
Hire it. Yeah.
Yeah. I like it.
I agree.
And this stuff, like the first one, both Arvid and me were like, this is like, yeah, okay, cool, but it's, there's room for improvement.
Well, looking just at the model, I think this is pretty good. But then I think, like, after it's like this, I think that's a render. It just feels way too simple. Like, there's no nice breakup here. Like, it's just, it feels like a flat surface, the ground. And overall, I think this is just too simple.
Yeah, and let me put this, there's like, 500 things like on ArtStation where they have like a medieval city, this, and it's like there's nothing stands out, and it's like I wouldn't hire somebody for the, there's like thousands of people. The other stuff I was like, oh, I haven't seen this, and then like the other guy, this guy is like
even from concept,
even the concept is like, it's like an octopus on top of an octopus or whatever, and it's like, that's pretty awesome. And it's like, it's moving. It's like, this is, we once, when I went to school, we did a crab with like six legs or something.
Okay.
And it was a shit show. It's like, is there any animation? And the crab had a thing, and then he picked something up, and he had like the things and six legs, and he was turning. Like, from, I didn't animate it, my buddy animated it, but it's a mess. It's like, even on Ants, on the Pixar movie, though, like the, it's Ants, the right?
Bugs Life?
Bugs Life. They made him like four legs because they couldn't handle six legs. You should look at it.
Look at it next time.
It's like a thing. Like, they said it, like, because like six legs, they said like, we couldn't do it with the timing. And then even here, like, if you look at lighting and stuff in the integration, it works.
It has the wiggle.
It works. It has some kind of way, and it's,
it's almost like a little bit of, I forgot his name, from Pirates, the guy.
David Jones. Jones, like Bastard Child.
Bastard Child. One thing I would say, obviously, it's just preference. I think that he's not heavy enough in terms of the animation. He feels like he's floating, and I would expect him to be a bit more heavy on the tentacles.
More like Mambas.
Yeah.
But
that's the only thing I would say. Otherwise, integration work, it's really good. I like the motion blurs matching to the plate. I think it's overall. The
lighting is good. Like, this is like, let's say, like, yeah.
Strong piece.
Yeah. And it's like, there's another dude. He's standing.
It's a bit dark here.
He's a little dark in the face.
And maybe integration, like, he works way better than the blue one, I think, in terms of integration.
Because like the blues already is pretty, it's a pretty unnatural color a little bit.
Like, you can see actually there is like a teal thing, like a cool box in the background here, which is definitely not as saturated as this. I think so. Maybe desat it and maybe make it a little bit lighter would work here.
He pops also a lot because he's so in your face, right?
Yeah. And then the wipe, before the wipe, it looks good. Here, this is nice, but then after comp, it looks like it's really dark then, yeah. Right? You agree?
You can bounce them a little bit. You can, even if it's cheated or whatever, like it is pretty dark. And yeah. But you can say like, you put a card and then it's like, this is what we do all the time with character. Like, yeah. Oh, you added like a bounce light from the floor. And then because you always see us like, yeah, you want to see us. Like if you showed us a daily, you would say, yeah, okay, yeah, it progress interpretation is good. Now we want to see what he's like. We want to read his expression.
Oh, this is not even comp yet. Okay.
Oh, okay. Sorry. Oh,
I'm so sorry. Oh,
sorry. We forgot. No, it's pretty good. Yeah. Everything, what we said, you did already.
Yeah. We take it back. Maybe it's a bit strong glow on it. That's maybe something I would say, like a bit of a bloom. But it's great, man. It's really good. Emilu, very good work.
I would like, if I were you, I would focus on these kind of things. And yeah. Then with this stuff, you can already work at a commercial company, and then
for sure,
go from there.
It's even like, this, man, this is looks so good.
Yeah, it's super cute. It's a nice design. This one. Like, yeah, it's really good.
Yeah, it's really a very strong piece. And if you want to present a reel, I would just have this and the other one. Like, it's really good stuff.
Even like the shading, this is actually not easy to make it like not disgusting. Also like octopus, it has like some like physical qualities, but it's also like you won't be afraid to touch it and stuff.
I think she did not do the shading. Oh, okay. So she did the lighting comp.
Okay, but
it's the lighting looks great. It looks very like integrated.
It's nice. No, it's good stuff.
All right, keep going here. Thank you very much for the submission.
Good stuff.
And then we pick The next one.
Riham Gamal.
Riham.
Was he there?
Oh. Did you see him already? There.
Yeah.
I think we got him though. Didn't we?
Maybe. Let's see. Is your magic thing not working?
I forgot to remove one. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
So sorry. Picking a new one. And we got
Ivan Manuel Benitez.
Benitez.
Okay.
Let's see. Ivan. There. A reel. Hello. Thank you very much for the opportunity. First reel and a few days ago. He's trying to get into industry as a junior. Hope you like it. Let's see.
Let's go from there.
Let's bring it up here. Lighting and comp. Okay, let's just do a first play and then we go into detail.
From there. Oh, yeah.
It's scattered.
Jurassic World.
Yeah. Good thing is I'm working on it right now, so I can talk a bit about Jurassic stuff. Adam looked at lighting comp.
Oh, yeah, like the Mary rig. I had to know.
That's what?
It's like it's an auto rig.
Oh,
I'm not sure what it looks like.
Z-Pass, Crypto Mat, lots of scattering. Let's see.
Likes to scatter.
He likes to scatter. Scatter is good, but it's very subtle. This looks chromatic as well.
I think with the breakdown, you start with the final piece and then go from there. It's a little.
Yeah. Oh, he's doing the other way, right?
Yeah, he's kind of building it up.
Yeah.
It's like, whoa.
Oh, that's from
Stranger Things.
Stranger Things.
Yeah.
Let's see, full screen. Okay.
Looks pretty good so far.
Oh, we should have done it the other way. I should have first done this one and then we flipped to the other one.
Sorry.
That's okay. All right, so let's talk look dev lighting comp. Dennis, what do you think?
I think... I would start with another piece, but I think the grass looks a little bit weird, and the dinosaur is a little like the shading. It's like he's like a black edge or something also.
Yeah,
like
I think just in general, like the spec, like the texture side, even the model does not hold up for this. Like it looks very simple in terms of there's no nice sculpt. Like I would expect the scales to pop. I would expect to see wrinkles. Like overall, this whole thing, even though it's for junior, I think you can definitely spend more time on the sculpt on this just to make the surface detail, because this is your hero, right? And you want to make him pop. And I think that's just lacking a bit. Like not a bit, it's actually lacking a lot of detail. And then this, you see this and like even in terms of modeling, it's like super thick here. And yeah, I think this is definitely not a very strong piece. In terms of composition, I think it's like the foreground is way too much. It doesn't really help with the scale as well. It feels like he's maybe not too big, right? If the grass is so small or so big in frame, he doesn't feel like it's a super huge dinosaur.
Yeah, there's a lot of some distracting. So.
Yeah, just keep going. So let's do like the animation stuff is definitely a lot better.
Yeah, it's cool. I would say it's a little bit, first glance, is a little bit too saturated.
Mm-hmm.
It's like everything is too, it's like the red is a little bit too red. You can't dial down. And then it's like, I feel like you have like this super blue light, but it doesn't really affect her, right? It's like, I think like maybe it's just like a volume he did in comp, like he colored it, like tinted it in comp. And then it's like, she's got...
Is that now? Okay, you can...
Oh, sorry, I'm just going to...
Yeah, okay.
And I think like, okay, like from what I'm understanding, this is a scene where she's like, oh, it's like a dream sequence where she's like dancing and now we're like back to reality.
Yeah.
And I think like the reality light looks a little bit more real, which is kind of like the point of it. And it's a little bit more. I think if you go back to this, it's too much. Like, where's this light coming from? And I get it, you want to push it, but also like this.
It's a bit much, right?
Yeah, it's a little bit over the top. And it's like also like, even if it's animation, you can look for a reference. Look for Las Vegas, whatever dancer, you know, absolutely. with the spotlights or circus, like Cirque du Soleil kind of stuff. Yeah. And then you just go from there. It always helps with this stuff.
And I think what I'm missing as well is that some breakup in the spotlights, it feels very smooth. Like maybe just some kind of like streaks or something.
You want like some kind of this.
Yeah. Let's see. And this one, I'm not sure exactly what we're looking at here. Like it's a bit bright here, right?
Well, that was sunk up though. Yeah, I think definitely like the gobo on his head looks wrong.
Yeah, this one, right? It's super sharp.
Like the mood and the color of the tone is nice, but it's a little bit. I think it's a little bit, too cheated. It's like the light on the boy is like it's not clear where it's coming from, or it's like it doesn't seem to affect him. Then this light on him has to be like super low, and it's like you don't see like if there would be a bright window, it might be. Something bright in the window, and then the stuff behind the windows also is very like
It's just like this one though, the backdrop is just a picture, I think.
And then even blur it more, like crank it up more or something.
I think again, even though we don't see much, I think this is the strongest one, like in terms of integration, in terms of shading the background and stuff. Like it's very short. Like, I would love to see a bit more of this one.
And even here, you can give him a little bit of bounce. You can see, like, a little bit, like, get the... I didn't know what it was. And it's, like, get, like, something a little bit here to see the teeth to make it...
Yeah, that's true. I agree.
Just a tiny bit.
But again, like, if I would rate your shots, I would say this one is...
Play it backwards,
basically. Yeah, exactly. Play it backwards. Maybe skip... Like, I would say this is... strongest than this, then this, and then this one. I would actually take this one out, to be honest.
Yeah.
But yeah, so thank you very much for the submission here. Let's keep going. Thanks, Ivan. Let's see.
Item removed.
And pick. You want to click?
Let me click.
Okay.
Here we go. Yeah. Juan Garcia.
I know him. I think I know him.
Let's do it.
Let's see. I think he's on Discord. Let's see. There he is. Fourth one to enter.
ArtStation.
Where is it here?
Oh, this looks cool.
Okay. Oh, yeah. Monkey.
Let's do the monkey. The monkey.
Monkey.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. full screen.
That's a cool monkey.
All right. You can drive. Let's go.
Okay. So... Actually, I'm pretty sure what did he do? Like, he's a model.
Generalist.
So he did everything.
I would guess. We can see credit for my client. In this case, I had to do modeling, sculpt, and everything. I had to paint, texture,
look, okay,
everything.
That's pretty impressive. That's pretty cool. I love the design. It's like the monkey, then he's like this tiny mouth. There's definitely cool some bold design choices. Good. Overall looks pretty cool. It's like it's the same as like the other set would work for a commercial or whatever.
Yeah, that's a commercial.
It's cool. It's fine. It's like yeah, like the groom here is a little, but this is all stuff. It's like okay, it's taste. It's not like the materials look good. It's like the hem looks like is a metal, right? Or it looks like aluminium metal. Or something. Yeah. If that's the eyes look all right, it's good. And I really, really like some subsurface going on a little bit.
Yeah.
This also like this is going working well. So okay.
Very simple, it's good though.
SEMA. It's probably for like
for the brand, I guess.
That's bike helmets or something.
So that's essentially a product, like the helmet is the product, yeah. I think. Maybe if I would say that the scratches are a bit much on it, like especially if it's a product you want to sell, you don't want to sell it with scratches. I think that's maybe something I would say as a client. And the eyes are good. I could maybe make them a little bit more realistic in terms of the reflection is a bit like I would expect maybe a nice light texture instead of just an area light in a reflection. Just to help a bit more detail.
Yeah, it's pretty blocky, but this is like stuff also you can comp just
dial
it in and out.
All right, let's go back here and see what else we pick. What is this? Does he have videos?
No. Like what is the robot?
This one?
The other one? Like the
this one?
The red one? Yeah.
Okay, let's show it.
He likes robot.
First thing I notice is the curvature is very, very standard. You just, there's no breakup in the curvature here on this hand. It's just like a wide rim, which is a bit weird.
But what I thought like on this pic is like the texture of the background is competing with the robot.
Yeah.
It's like, yeah, you want to present the robot, then just do like a
backdrop or something.
Like right? A side, like, yeah, backdrop or like less texture or whatever. This looks cool.
Can I make this not full? Why can't I make this mine? Just do this then.
And yeah, I mean the materials look all right. It looks good.
Yeah.
It's just, yeah, if you look at it again, it's the monkey. It's like definitely it's the monkey.
Yeah, it's definitely the monkey is the strongest. Let's look at this. We're just picking the ones we just think is the stronger pieces here.
Oh, that's cool stuff.
I like the heads-up display here.
Yeah. And it's also like it's really good material, it's really good detail, really good. This breakup, it's not too much, not too crazy, nothing is competing. It's a lot of stuff, it's a lot of detail, but it still works in the silhouette. It's like you got like this kind of like insect kind of like thing. You got like he pushed the tubes there and stuff. And
I like the carbon shader
on it's really good. Yeah. And it's like, this is really good texturing and look there.
In terms of composition, maybe I would like to lift him a bit from the plate. Like he looks like it's a bit dark, the background. Maybe a rim to lift him.
Or you just brighten up the background.
Yeah, or just brighten up the background.
But yeah, this is really like, this is high quality.
High quality shit. Good stuff.
Good stuff.
Juan, I would say.
This is stuff like, this would work easy as an asset at ILM or whatever.
I wasn't sure what this is. Isn't it
like from Prometheus? Or it's like no, it's different.
Is it not? Yeah, maybe not.
Or maybe it's like based on it. It's like
I don't know. It looks a bit unfinished.
Yeah, Infectio.
And that's I guess where it's from.
Mm.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's kind of. I think it's like similar mood or something. He looks a little like ceramic, like plastic.
Yeah. Okay. Next one.
Yeah. It's good stuff. It's really high quality work.
Like if we would pick again, let's just grab a quick look at this one. I think this one is also amazing. Like in terms of detail, I think this is like also a very strong one.
Yeah. Like all the hard surface stuff is good. It's cool design. It's like,
I think like monkey first and maybe actually this one first. Like I like the Oblivion's thing here and then monkey and then this. The other ones, like the face looking at it is not super strong. Right, let's keep going. Next one. So we just switch back to this. What time do we have, actually?
Mm-hmm.
11:45, 54. How long are we going? 2 hours already. Okay, we just do maybe a few more, and then we're done already. Yeah. Right, next up is Rattani Cam.
Rattani Cam. Where is he?
Here he is. He has an attachment, I think.
Four attachment.
So okay. Old school way.
PNG.
PNG. Looks like a sunny day. Yeah, it's actually...
It changes the whole time. It's like Vancouver. It can be winter. It can be summer. It's like...
Can be anything. Let's kind of do this. Oh, is it so small?
It's red.
Yeah, he sent me like four images in my email account, which is a bit awkward to load. I could...
Tomatoes.
Do we have tomatoes? No. And I'm not even... It's super hard to... Yeah, it's... Yeah, let's just do this. Man, it's so... They look good.
They look good.
Why are they so small, though?
No. 6 MB. They shouldn't be so small. I think you can zoom in.
No.
Maybe when you do just drag them over.
I think I need to download them.
Okay. Then just download them.
Yeah, I'm not sure. I think we should, let's just do this. Like, we will just be a bit faster now because this is not the best representation, even though it looks good. Oops, no, I killed it. Yeah, now I messed it up. Let's see, there he is. This one, what is on? Sorry about race. We definitely need to streamline the process a bit more. Okay, so let's just, did it actually now replace them? Or I'm freaking out. Yeah, now everything is messed up. I messed up.
Oh boy.
Let's just work on the tomatoes. I think just drag them over. Sorry, like we can just talk about this a bit. Like obviously, like he's got like four images, and I think like photoreal, this is pretty good. Let's just make it in full screen.
Yeah, it looks in the cut, so it looks good.
It looks nice and juicy, and the table is it looks like the table has subsurface scattering on, which is a bit weird here. There's some kind of color bleeding.
Or maybe this is the chromatic aberration.
Oh yeah, you might be right. It's here too.
But in terms, for example, like what I like about this image is like he wants to showcase his skills on the tomatoes, so he presents it in a rigged way. He blurs out everything. Uses the depth of field. There's texture on the table, but it's not distracting. It's not pulling away the focus from the tomatoes. So it's a very successful tomato.
I agree. This is but let's just open. The other one was also pretty good, I think. And then we just keep going. I'm not sure exactly. Oh man, it's so small. I'm not sure exactly what he did on this. Like, he did not give any info. Like, if it's a full CG one, it's pretty good. Like, I think it's like the cell phone maybe is a bit too cartoony. Guess no one can see shit. okay, let's just skip it. It's random. Yeah, it is random. What is it? Yeah. So we were picking a random people here, but maybe we got lucky. Next one. Da-da-da-da. Copis Digital.
Copy is digital.
Oh, what is
that? That's a weird name. How can you name your kid like this? Just kidding.
Did you see it already?
No.
There. Okay, lots of text here. Photographer, strong transfer, CGI VFX. I don't have a website portfolio, but I do post Instagram page, digital copyist. Okay, let's just do a quick look-see here. I'm not sure if we get what we want. Instagram. Does that work? Okay, so I hope it's him.
I think so.
Sava Maksimovic. Artisan, what do you say? Digital. Okay, so let's just do this full. All right, what do we see? We see renders. We don't see much, unfortunately. I'm not sure what to say. This looks all very basic still. Like, it's very junior work, I think.
Yeah, and it's also like the one problem is like, you see, like, we were like, okay. First thought for us every time we look at stuff is like, okay, what are we looking at? And then it's like, that's why presentation is so important. It's like you say like, oh, I want to become, I'm like a lighting or look dev guy, or like I'm a modeler that also does texturing. And it's like, just say something about yourself, say something about the work, and the way presented is also very important
Yeah, it's hard for us to comment on this. There's so much stuff scattered all over. It's like, if you want to get a submission, like a good feedback from us, send us like an art station, or send us like a reel, and which we can give you better feedback on.
Yeah, reel is the best. And it's like, if you don't want us to do like talks about some stuff, then don't send it. Like, it's like,
exactly.
Like, this is like what we see is send it, and then make sure it's like, well, what you think is the strongest, put it in the beginning, and then. Because this is also how the companies work. If they look at stuff, your first image on the reel isn't that great. Like some recruiters, they already like you go to the box.
Exactly.
It's the reality, and it's super tough.
All right. We have another one, which is Daniel Evans from Bournemouth University.
Bournemouth is UK.
Okay. UK. All right.
Bournemouth is a good university. Developership.
Oh, yeah. You see, this is exactly that. It's he's doing character work.
Character work. He likes Marvel. He likes comic books.
He likes Chappie.
He likes the stuff. And it's, yeah.
Okay, that's just, which one do we pick? Captain?
That's the Chappie. I like the
Chappie.
Chappie, yeah.
Okay. Oh, yeah. Oh, I think I saw this actually in on Discord. So we did see this on another channel. Okay, interesting. Full screen. Okay, let's go Chappie. Let's see. Well, so I think, did you work on Transformers?
I worked on Bumblebee, yeah.
Bumblebee, there you go. Yeah. I worked on The Last Knight, so we both have like a robot experience. The robot stuff, okay. 24 seconds, modeling. Oh, that's his reel, actually. That's great.
Oh, okay, reel is awesome.
Lots of flickering going on here.
It's okay.
We can ignore it. The coke tin is a bit weird.
Yeah, it looks like something broke on the coke.
The flickering really annoys me.
Done. You're fired.
And where's the rest? Okay, we just see this now. Okay, I guess.
It's if you're saying for modeling, it's pretty impressive. Also, it's a good exercise. Yeah, it's like you recreated Chappie. You can double check how he looks. There's lots of reference.
Yeah.
There's a lot of work. There's a lot of detail.
I agree. Yeah, I think the wall is a bit. Taking focus, like it's a bit distracting for me. Maybe it's a bit too bright. Maybe like
and too much going on. It's too busy. Yeah,
it's a bit busy. All in all, I would say the modeling is pretty good, except the coke tin, which is totally distracting. Like it's really taking off the quality of the whole thing. Like let him hold a stick or something. I don't know. it just feels very simple in terms like in terms of like how he's looking, like on texture work is pretty good. Obviously there's always a bit more things you can do to break it up. Like the surfaces here feel very smooth. I would expect him to be broken up a bit more. Oh, our camera is dead. Yeah, thanks. Let me just fix it.
Sorry.
Oof. No, it's okay. You can keep talking, Dennis.
Okay. Yeah, it is overall, it's pretty good. I think I saw like a making of where they were actually talking about how they simulated the chains. It was like a big issue because he's wearing so much change and they had like a big sim setup for it because it's like he's running and jumping and it was like a big big issue with the chains in the beginning. It's kind of interesting.
You can still drive, I think, if you okay. Can go over my arms here.
And let's see what we got. How do I go back?
I think you just okay, I think we're back.
We're back.
We are back.
We're back.
I just, as you guys know already, that I'm still waiting for that cable.
Oh, the rocket looks also really good.
Nice conversation.
Yeah. Yeah, Arvid is getting a new cable. He's killing it. And yeah, let's have a look at Rocket here. Yeah, overall looks pretty impressive. It's a little bit noisy here, but it's. I saw this one too somewhere. Yeah, there's a lot of detail. Even the teeth and stuff. Yeah, it's really good work. There's some stuff here like where it looks a little bit thick, but this is all like, there's, considering he's still in school, there's not much to complain about. What else we got? We got, no, I don't like the DG doubles.
I'm back. Harrison Ford.
Harrison Ford.
Honestly, lots of hair.
Lots of hair. And this is actually, this is pretty good. It's like,
all school, all good, all good. Yeah, we're going. Cool. Oh, that's cool. Oh, wait, okay.
So oh, now it's like,
you got it per guy.
Per guy.
Yeah, for likeness, I think he's a bit off still. It looks a bit weird in his eyes, I guess. Like, the eyes are a bit awkward.
He has some red eyes, but overall, I think it's...
Definitely, yeah. It looks painted almost, like...
Yeah, there's like a painterly quality to it.
Did you champion him?
I did champion and Rocket.
Rocket, okay. Yeah. Let's just do a quick captain. Yeah, I think his eyes are weird. I think the hard surface stuff works very well, but then again, look, and then the skin, like it I think it breaks in terms of quality.
Yeah.
Like the ears are stretched, the eyes are, it looks very low poly. But the hard surface stuff is pretty good. Right, next one.
Yeah, I'll be also.
Yeah, one sec. Yeah. So we're all taking a few breaks here. It has been already 2 hours, and I want to thank everyone for joining. I think we have almost, what did I just see? 90 viewers here on Twitch. That's pretty impressive. I think that's my channel record. Let's see. I don't have that overlay there, so I don't want to switch scenes all the time. 85, so that's pretty good. Thank you, everyone. Yeah, I'm happy you guys. I hope it's good. Like, obviously, you guys, I think, have seen way more portfolio reviews on Twitch. So this is our first attempt at this. So I like that Dennis is here. I've seen other ones where it's just like audio or something like that. It's cool that we can interact. I think that works a bit better. Never enough reviews, yeah. And I think what I want to do next is do a bit more organized to maybe have the person who actually presented their reel, maybe have them in the stream, like on a Zoom or something. But anyways, let's keep going. I don't want to waste your time, and we need to keep going for sure. So let's go here, remove Daniel, and see who we have next. Milad Berhari. And let's see if I find him. Mihad. Let's see. There he is. So he's got several ArtStation ones. Let's see. Personal projects. So let's load him up. I hope this is all his work here. Huh. Okay. Major content. Okay, so he has good stuff, I think. Alexander Furry. You guys know Alexander Richter? Oh man. Anyways, okay, so the first thing I'm looking at this here is the first piece, which is hand drawn, I believe, very stylized. And I think that's catching my eye, and then the lady. So these are very strong pieces. Let's just look at this quickly. So it's actually not painted. It's actually rendered. That's nice. I would
love to see a turntable of this one.
Yeah. So this is, I think, maybe he did like an Instagram filter or something, and then he recreated that. I think it's a very good idea. And it's very close to the illustration. That's really cool. Oh, he's in the chat. Hello. Thank you guys, for submitting your work here. Much appreciated. Let's see major content, and let's just do it.
Oh boy.
No naked ladies. That's all good. It's very cool. I like the story. It's nice. It's very, very stylized, very cartoony. The proportions are really cool. Zombie head, blood. It's good. It's definitely good for cartoon, like animation.
Yeah,
right?
This is making good stuff. Yeah, for sure.
Even like the overall, like how you present it and the feel, it has this nice quality to everything. I really enjoy it. Like in terms of the rigging and the placement is
should apply cool. To Sony, like they're looking a lot for like this stylized kind of things. After Spider-Man, they're doing a lot of movies that get more on the stylized stylized direction, and yeah it's
totally Taylor, yeah. Taylor Swift in an African tribe outfit.
Neck.
Yeah. Oh, we've got a whole reel here.
Whoa.
Very close up. Nicely detailed here. Maybe the eye is lacking a bit of detail. I mean, like the whole eye thing here, but the scales.
Everything is like
good, right?
Like, it's like a, like,
yeah,
a, like
it's pretty good.
National Geographic.
Yeah.
Close up thingy.
There he is. Turntail right out of ZBrush, I believe. Little frog. I think that's a very strong one. So, is that a female? I think so. Female Santa? Oh, maybe not.
No.
It looks a bit female, right?
It looks
right?
Very, like, yeah, female.
Oh, is it cool? It's from Up, right? No, maybe.
No, no, but it's similar. They have the...
These weird creatures,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, but it's the same color. So. Also, it's like a nice twist on a dragon. You see so many dragons, and this is something where really...
I'm not sure if he's kidding, but yeah. No, that's, Mila, that's really strong.
That's really stuff. It's like, and what is also like, you look at it in this stuff, like similar as the what was like the lady with the Kraken, with the octopus.
Oh, yeah.
It's like, okay, we see something, we haven't seen this in a while, and it already like, it strikes your eye, right? So it's like, yeah. It's impressive stuff.
Definitely good. Like really, like everything. Like I wouldn't see anything which is out of place. I think they all have a really great quality to it. Maybe let's look at this. Yeah, I'm not sure what you did here. I've done character texture, made some posters. So you did texture. Texture work is like pretty good.
Commissions work.
Yeah.
Commission work.
Yeah, great stuff, Milad. Really good work, and I'm sure if you present this, maybe do a nice reel, like animate, make some nice turntables from them, and then you can definitely apply for all the big companies. I'm pretty sure they would be happy to have a talented artist like this. It's really cool work.
Yeah, it's really unique, and it's unique style, and this is like really like what's really interesting.
Yeah. All right, keep going. So who do we have next? Daniel Field. Let's just find him. Daniel. Lots of Daniels. Daniel Field. Long text.
It's Vimeo. Showreel link.
Showreel link. And he's from the UK. It's a bit dated. And let's bring up the full screen and then we can just keep going and then we talk about it. All right, Dan Field, 3D artist. Modeling, texturing. Modeling's a bit basic. I'm missing the, yeah, let me talk about it a bit. Hey Ludo, thanks for joining. Yeah, I'm Dinek. Yeah, nice. I think I joined your stream recently. And I was asking what you actually do. I think the modeling here, yeah, let's talk about it in a bit. Is maybe a bit basic.
Yeah, it's better.
That's better, yeah. I think you just combine them all, maybe.
I like what first struck me is like, it's like I'm not, it's very different.
All over quality.
And it's very, I don't really, okay, like this, is this like, is this like a work in progress? Because like definitely like these arms, they don't look like they are like textured or whatever. Or it's like.
Yeah, I agree.
And what is the spine mod? Okay.
Yeah, I think it's hard to see like what is the hero in the shot, right? I guess it's this piece, but then why is it not featured more, right? It's like I would expect maybe some beams or something like to be just very like in your face, and I think these arms just take away the quality.
Yeah, take like the yeah.
Let's see, and again, it feels like in terms of quality. It's all over the place. Like there is like
there's some stuff that is like decent quality, and there's some stuff where it looks like it's a work in progress or it's not quite finished yet. And
yeah, like this for instance, I'm not sure. This looks very simple and very basic. But then there's like better, like this works a lot better, like this Everlast boxing bag. It's very simple too, though. It's nothing really where you say, wow, that's amazing, I think. What do you say? Yeah,
it's like I don't know, it's like, okay, like it's hard for me, like if I would be like recruiter at this studio, okay, what do you want to do? Like you want to modeling or like you want to do texturing? And then it's like, okay, show me the best what you can do. And then I see it. Yeah. Okay, it's like I don't know, like what are you showing me? Like what is like the, and it's like these eyes is like I don't know really what you wanted to okay. Do they belong to character or like things? Yeah. It's a little bit all over the place. There's good aspects in it, but it's hard to guess what's happening.
Okay. Yeah, cool. I think definitely there's still lots of work to do on it. Like look at reference, especially like here, like this, like there's stretching going on. Like this always feels very simple. So obviously you got to polish it if you want to make this work. Like it's, even like if you look at the basketball here, like the balls would not even fit through the hoop here. At least that's what I'm looking at here. So there's lots of things, room of improvement. But thanks anyways for submitting your work here. So let's pick another one. Who do we get now? Rikesh.
Let's see.
Rikesh. Main there. He's got ArtStation as well. Oh, looks good. Good. Like, again, like the first piece is very good. That's just, and I think this is really good. Like, if I could say something, I think it lacks a bit of shading detail. Like, the lips feel a bit too plasticky. I don't see it very smooth. Like, there's no scattering going on, maybe. That's something I would say. Overall, it feels a bit like there's no micro displacements going on in terms of the spec breakups, but the modeling is pretty great.
Yeah, it's like,
all right, so everyone is back. I'm sorry for that it broke. Like, I'm not sure why, what happened here. I guess OBS was just not liking it. So there's also a turntable, I believe. Let's just play this back. And yeah, I think it's fairly good. Let's see the other pieces. Like, I like this one. That's really cool.
Oh, yeah. It's also kind of like a 2D-ish look, right?
It really feels nice. It has this new fresh style of like presenting stuff. It's not like the typical model you see or the typical render. It's very artistic, I would say. Creative is the right word. It's really cool. Let's see if we find something else. Is that just sculpting, right?
Yeah.
Clay modeling.
Can you do the cyber?
This?
No, this one? Yeah. Yeah, that's also pretty cool.
Yeah. Is it, but it's sketch, right? Is it?
What is it?
Model based and mesh sculpted. Okay.
ZBrush. Eh?
Yeah.
Oh, you can do this video if you go up.
Yeah. It's 3D. Okay. Sad person. Strong posture here. What's this one? That is painted though. Oh, that's a sketch and then the concept.
Yeah.
It's very, I like it. The style is nice.
The same hair as the other one. Was it the same person?
As the glowing lady?
Yeah. It's always similar. No, like
oh, this one. Yeah.
Also like the
it's like the same technique.
Hair, yeah, like belly.
That's pretty cool. I like the concept art here. Really nice depth.
Good stuff, man.
All right. Let's keep going. What about the giant? Okay, he's asking. What about the giant? The giant?
This giant?
Oh, did you miss it? We talked about the giant. The giant is great. That's like a really great piece, and you could totally apply it for any like bigger company with this. I'm pretty sure this will be amazing.
Yeah.
Unless you were talking about the other giant, but I don't think so. Or the Viking. Yeah, this lacks a bit of facial detail.
It's a nice sword.
Huh? Nice sword.
Yeah, sword.
All right, let's pick another one here. All right. Let's see. Stefan Hampel. sounds German, and I know he is. I was at his stream already.
Where is he?
We've seen him already in this in the list. He's doing crazy stuff, actually. but he's not there. Where is he? You saw him too, right? There he is. ArtStation. STF. I always feel like, shut the fuck up. That's always what I'm looking.
Yeah, STFU would it be then.
Yeah, that's true.
Okay, look at this. Oh, you got
Hamburg City. So I have seen this piece, which is really mind-blowing. Let's just bring it up. So that's full CG.
That's good. Is he doing the rookies too? No.
I don't think... No. Stefan, are you at the rookies? Did you participate? I'm not sure.
Yeah, it looks pretty good.
Yeah, the only thing which I think gave notes on, I'm not sure, I don't think he addressed it, is the size of the boxes and the bottles are a bit large. And then the female here, I think it's just a 2D image.
Can I
just... Yeah, just remove it. You don't need them, I think.
Yeah.
Even he looks a bit out of proportion.
The people going in, you can't tell, right?
But overall, like, this is it's pretty strong. It's pretty good. Like, look at this. Like, it's he actually did model it.
Yeah.
Interesting.
Like a library or something. You know, you do a movie with a little pen or something. It would be
Yeah, exactly. Just to see, like, some kind of reflections or pings.
Yeah.
It's really cool. Let's see. Then we have this, which I've seen on the Discord channel.
It's a recreation from Lego Movie 1.
From the Lego Movie, yeah. And it feels like, I love the bounce light. I like the feel that everything is like self-illuminating almost, or not self-illuminating.
They did like on the Lego stuff, they did a really like, I'm working with some Animalogic guys right now that have worked on it. And they said like they did a lot of research for the first one, at least with all the lenses. And they did a lot of test shoots because like everything behaves differently. And the Lego, the plastic, and they shoot light and they shoot Lego. Yeah. And anamorphic lenses, so they were really trying to make it physical accurate.
Yeah, that's I really love it. Really good stuff. And let's see, he's got lots of good stuff. I think he also showed a commercial about that. I think he just worked on it, so it wasn't a personal project. Tokyo Drift full 3D CGI breakdown, personal project, free time.
Tokyo Drift is on Netflix right now.
Oh yeah,
it's a really good movie. It's one of the
sponsored by Netflix. is that
like, is it like, well, what is it, is it like, is this his,
I just made it full.
Okay, this is all full studio one.
It's a bit dark and our room here is super bright. It's hard to see. I'm not sure if,
like, let's see what he's doing.
So that's comp now. Okay, that's interesting.
This is said 4CG breakdown, so he said he did it.
I guess he's talking over it.
Place the buildings exactly.
He is, but we're just new. Sorry.
Man, wow, that's good.
It's very impressive. Like, I was like, what is he? Is that full CG?
The second layer was the flex layer. And the
okay, wow, he did all the cars, all the stuff. Procedural
noise is a V-Ray.
Called Orange Peel. The cars had to be colorful to fit the Tokyo Drift style.
I want to see the movie.
Yeah, I'll play it back in a bit. Some comp work. Let's play the movie.
But this is his render one?
No, okay, this is the idea.
Okay. So, and then he has his still frame. That's what he did.
Okay. I thought this was the CG.
Yeah.
That's from the movie.
Yeah.
I really love Japanese architecture and automotive CGI.
I got it.
So I just thought, yeah, you should.
Okay, so the idea. CGI, and then how does it continue?
My image.
Comp. Okay, so that's then this. Okay.
See. But it looks pretty good. Yeah.
Okay, now I get
it. I won't give you feedback. Okay, so lots of people gave you feedback. Okay, I like this one as well. Just in terms of the mood. Oh man, yeah,
this is really nice.
Really cool stuff. Like, just the mood and the warmth of I think it's like about to get spring, I guess. Everything starts to melt. Like, it feels like it's like a warm day and it starts to melt, and it's just really cool.
Really impressive modeling. This, yeah, it's really good.
Yeah. Even this, like, this is a product shoot render. I would expect maybe a bit more distortion on these lines. I feel a bit too straight and the windows is a bit too clean. But that's his reference again. So I'm not even sure what I'm doing here. Okay.
No, it's really good. And then like all the detail in the snow and
Another pick? Maybe this one?
Yeah.
London?
Yeah, look, that's London.
Full CG. The Market Porter.
Never been there.
Never been there. It's almost like from Fantastic Beasts a shot.
Yeah.
Well, they were in New York, but anyways.
Oh, they were London too, I think.
Was it British?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. You're right. All right.
Yes, thanks. Everything is super high quality.
Yeah,
fucking awesome. Yeah.
You should definitely get a job in VFX. Like, just use your latest pieces here, create a nice reel, like maybe do some camera rendering.
When you're smart, you don't. You will do a job in visual effects.
Yeah, if you're smart, you don't. NHB Studios. I think I.
NHB is big. They joined with Zezocht now.
Okay. Oh, no. Zezocht. Yeah.
NHB, no. They joined with Liga 01. NHB is they have all offices in Cologne. It's like a post production. They do commercials.
I worked at Liga 01 like in Hamburg for like
few weeks. Similar stuff.
Okay. Right. Let's just pick two more and then we're good. So Stefan, and next is
Cesar Pinada.
Cesar. You're always looking through the microphone. Dagan, where is he? There he is. All right. I hope you're doing okay. I'm doing okay. I just finished my study last month, so here's my portfolio. So let's look at it. Okay. Are we full? Yeah, we are. So first glance, it feels still very junior, just in terms of the overall quality of things. I'm not sure which is the latest. I guess this one.
As he's just asking, is it hard to get a job as a character artist at ILM? Thing is, I would say actually yes, it is hard.
I would say so too.
Because the thing is, like, modeling at ILM is a really small department. And then like the character stuff is, most of stuff's done in San Francisco, right?
Yeah, it is.
And then even if you get the job, that's what I'm saying, is like you won't be doing like the Martin Scorsese, like the head off, or you won't do like Iron Man or whatever. You would probably, you do variation 500 of X-Ray, update new canon and then publish it. It is, that's what I'm saying. It's like all these, it's kind of tricky. If you want to get more into this creature work, you should apply to like a commercial place where you get like, I don't know, there you can get, they need a cool creature and you got lucky and you do it from the get-go.
Yeah.
And whereas like at ILM, it's like, even if you do the creature, it's like so many people working on it. It's so many iteration and then there's a client and it's, it's tricky.
Yeah. And we both know a few people in SF because we work with, like, SF and Vancouver offices are pretty much treated as one office. So we, like, I work with Chris Coster, who's like a creature modeler and he's doing an amazing job, and quite a few other people. So it's definitely, they are all like, it's the core of ILM people are in SF who do like the high end work. I think like it's hard to give advice on this. Like, everything feels a bit too simple still. Maybe this one is more or less.
I saw this at the Rookies too. I think.
You saw it at the Rookies?
Yeah.
I think it's just look at references, which is the best advice I can give you. That's mostly the main thing I would say, is just look at references and just compare the one-to-one. I think that is very important. What else? These ones are obviously, like, I don't want to even open it. It looks like very, very, very simple. What do we have here? Maybe is that some integration work? SF has become smaller, that's true. Obviously we can't go into much detail here, but SF is definitely a bit smaller than it used to be. Anyways, let's switch to the next one, right?
Yeah.
All right. Johnny Fair. I think I've seen him as well before. Let's go way up. There was a Johnny. Coole Aktion. Yeah, man. Liebe Grüße aus der Schweiz. Website or ArtStation?
Thank you.
Okay, let's see your website. Maybe website has is real. graphic design, 3D design, music production, mastering. Let's do 3D. Okay, let's have this. I maybe open up this one and see what we have here.
We got double.
Oh, wow. Tons of stuff.
That's almost too much.
Yeah, it's too much. What? It's not too much, but it's good to have lots of things, but only have your strong pieces.
Let's do the Star Wars army.
Yeah, we just do it here. This one here, yeah?
Yeah.
B1 Battle Droid.
Yeah. There was another. Can you skip to?
Skip to what?
Yeah, another shot with the army on the other one. Like, death. Sorry. This one. I like this one. It's kind
of. Droid army, yeah. Yeah, it's pretty cool. Actually, I think, Johnny, that you gave me your model, right? Like, I did some lighting on this, right? Is that you? I believe it is. Yeah, it looks really cool. Like, it's maybe a bit too perfectly symmetrical. Like, there's no offsets, no random rotations, which I would like to see. But in general, this is a very cool one. And that has worked on Star Wars, so he would know. Right?
Yeah. No, it looks... just reading the chat, sorry.
Yeah, that's okay. Let's see.
No, I think it looks better than the original.
The original ones were like super simple, right?
Yeah, they were from 1999.
It's maybe a bit much breakup here, like this maybe a bit much.
I think a little bit steampunk take on it, but I like it. Oh. It's pretty cool.
What else? Some close-ups. I think I've seen it as well somewhere.
Looks pretty good, yeah.
Yeah. It's maybe like, yeah. No, it's actually pretty good. The background was a bit distracting, I thought. Maybe it's a bit much. Okay, thanks, Stefan. Thank you very much. Yeah, we will do it a bit more. I think we will do a similar take how Andrew's doing. We will see how it turns out. Definitely very strong portfolio here.
Yeah, that's also cool stuff.
Wow, it's really cool. Like the attention to detail here, like with the graffiti and the tagging, and it's really good. The grass and whatever is here on the floor. It's really nice attention to detail. What is this? Asus Workflow Maya Redshift. I'm not sure. Is this like a tech demo?
It's probably like a tutorial.
Yeah, it's just a tutorial. Okay.
Yeah, I mean, this stuff looks great. It's like
graffiti. Oh, he's got the graffiti decals, I guess. So he created those, I guess, and then used it in his renders.
Makes sense, yeah.
Makes definitely sense. Some, yummy.
This works pretty good.
Yeah, the orange is a bit weird, maybe
a
too
bit
reddish.
Too much and too much display.
So yeah, too much, yeah.
Might be this guy, what is it? Is it the right ones? What is it called? Like
water, like it's a melon?
Oh, melons.
Okay. It's not watermelon, but it's a melon.
Oh, yeah, also a little bit too much displacement.
Yeah, it's all though, looking nice.
Yeah.
All right, I think we picked the last one.
Last one.
What time do we have? 10:12:35. Okay, so... The next portfolio review, yeah, we'll see. We just started, so we'll see. I have a few more buddies in comp, so they also said, yeah, they want to do it too. So maybe I'll need to get a couch in here so we have a, like almost like corridor floor or something. We do some kind of comp lighting, looked at reels. We'll see. All right, Tom Roma.
Sounds German.
Very German.
Or Swedish. No.
No, not Swedish. Yeah, I have a list of names, actually. Like I got them sent over via email. So we have almost 60 entries, and this little hat here is picking a random name from all those emails. I just need to find Timo. Tom.
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 There we go.
Pixel Vision Cologne.
ArtStation and the Rookies.
ArtStation and the Rookies.
Let's do ArtStation.
Let's do ArtStation.
Or I had him already.
Tom Moyman.
Ooh, this looks good.
Dortmund. Borussia. Whoop, whoop. Okay, so which we pick first?
Yeah, let's do main.
Yeah. All right. For, it looks like already looking at this, the sun feels very overpowering and it's hard to actually read anything. It's just so bright. And I think with so much sun hitting the wall, I think there would be way more bounce in the scene.
Yeah, and it looks, I mean, it's hard to, it's like the streaks are pretty sharp, but it might be accurate, but it's like, yeah, it's a cool graphic effect, but it doesn't, it's hard to read it. Like, this works a little bit better.
That's a ref, he says, this one.
But this looks like CG2,
that's
right?
CG2. That's one thing I can tell you is never do CG and base it off another CG render, because the person who did that CG render might have not
already
did,
cheated.
Yeah, already cheated, did some weird thing. So always, if you do references, always take, make sure it's a picture.
Or like a painting.
Or a painting, yeah. Because like even looking at the ref, it feels too dim, too dark. Like I would expect way more bounce here. And then he tried to replicate that and it just got a bit more dark, like a bit more moody. Let's pick this one. Metallic, very metallic. Whatever that thing is.
It's like a comp, no.
Like looks compass. Like a calendar.
Yeah.
April, some kind of thing. It's small though. If this is my ring,
it's like a saucer.
It's very small. Okay, that's.
It looks good though. Like,
let's see this one. This is cool. See, always moving pictures, we're already happy. Well, I am.
No, it looks good.
Could be from Will Smith movie with the dog.
I Am Legend.
I Am Legend. Yeah. Where the city is just.
Or like, what is the game? Like the what's coming out now? The Last of Us or something.
Okay.
Like this is also like similar.
It's cool. Yeah. It's maybe a bit too saturated. Maybe.
Yeah. It looks a little bit like if there's like a filter on, comp filter, but like, yeah, it's lots of detail. It's good stuff.
Is that Rookies Award here?
Oh, yeah.
Netflix Skill Contest, held by the Rookies. Excellent award.
Oh, yeah.
Took 1 month to complete. Thank you very much, Shannon. Thanks for joining. All right, so let's see. I'm always like, it's maybe a bit too much smudges and breakup on it.
Oh, it looks pretty good.
It looks pretty good.
It's like, yeah.
Bit of flicker. Oh, that was short. Let's see, yeah. The table,
like, yeah, it's also like, same stuff. It's like, you want to focus on the simplified table a bit, like the less displacement can be like a bit more simple, but yeah, no, I think these rusty things, the light might be a little bit too.
Yeah. Like I would be very sad if my watch would look like this, to be honest, right? If I have a gold watch and it's like,
but does rust. Gold like rust?
I don't think it does.
Does corrode?
I don't think it does corrode.
Maybe it's a fake watch.
So that's a Chinese watch. Sorry, no, I didn't want to say that. So I think it's a bit much on the breakup. Like I love it, it's great, but I think it's a bit much. Like especially on the front here, on the cover, maybe it's a bit much. All right, controller
seems to be like a big thing. See, there's actually some smudging and stuff.
And this is not smooth anymore.
Yeah, like, it's a little bit dirty.
It's a bit like.
Yeah,
rough.
I get it. Yeah, okay. No, this looks
weird though.
It's plastic.
The knob.
Yeah.
What is it? Obviously, different brand. Okay, that's totally
different brand. It's like you can compare X with apples or whatever.
This has definitely, like, the one thing I'm noticing here, just obviously, it's just now when I look at things, is the start button and select, they all look very faded and used. But then playing myself on the controller, I know that the joysticks, they fade off very quickly, especially where you grip with your thumb. So I would expect that should be a way more breakup, and even the square, the pinkish square looks way too bright. Those colors are
look really bright,
as if they are the light source.
Yeah, they look always like in the incandescent.
Yeah, I like how the Sony logo fades a bit, and you can see it has been used, but then it does not, like, you would need to do the same thing on the other objects as well. Yeah. One last pick, this one maybe. Okay. Watch. Substance S.
Superman.
Oh, Superman. I always used to draw these S's in school. You do like three lines vertically, three like that, and then you just connect them.
That's smart.
It's very good. It's very good. Bit of aliasing issues. Pink Floyd. I'm not sure. Oh, that's a sticker on this.
Yeah, it's a sticker. So everything is about stickers.
Stickers. Vans. It's good. It's very close up, though. Like, it's...
This looks a little weird. Like, yeah. I think plastic wouldn't have this stuff. Like this.
Yeah, this
would be more metal or like burn or what.
Back in the day. Yeah.
He was like, the latest Star Wars was mostly Clarice or Render Man, the final battle with many ships. I think the final battle with ships was all Render Man. It's like, how works at ILM? It's like you got the generalist department and they're rendering environments. And sometimes they render also like ships, like hero asset, and I think some shots the Star Destroyers were rendered in Clarice, but I would say 80% was run in RenderMan.
Yeah,
because
it's the main thing, right?
I worked on it, and we were, yeah, it was all the Star Destroyers were RenderMan. I think there was one or two shots where it was done in Clarice for some reason because there was some interactions with something, but yeah.
Oh. So then we have a question from Lukowski. Was it Lukowski? No, sorry, it was Ankit Mishra. If we have any references for portfolios which we follow, and I think the main advice we can, like, I personally don't have anything which, oh, this is great. I just go essentially on LinkedIn and check my followers, more or less how they do it, and then I obviously talk to my colleagues and friends and ask them about the quality of my reel. And essentially what I'm doing is I'm just trying to get the strong pieces in first and then average pieces in the middle, and then the last two or something are strong again, so that when your reel finishes, you show your best work or like one of the better works again in the end. And one thing I could say is, don't think that you need to make a reel 5 minutes long. No one will look at it. Make it between 1 minute maybe, and maybe 1 and 2 minutes.
For a start, you can even do 30 seconds.
Even 30 seconds.
It's fine. Like yeah. We said, like with the octopus guy, yeah. We were both like, okay, this is good. And then when the city came, we're kind of, just like, okay. And then the first impression, it is stupid, but it is like this. It's like, oh, you're the girl with the octopus.
Yeah.
It's like, okay, yeah, this is cool.
Exactly.
Like, and this is what people remember. And then when recruiters look at the stuff, it takes 10 seconds and it's like, okay, it's already tough.
And then Lukowski, thanks for doing this. My portfolio didn't get reviewed, but thank you so much for doing this. You guys rock. Thank you for all the submissions. That is amazing. You guys rock.
Oh, thank you. Hey, would you still recommend moving to Vancouver? I think it's tricky right now.
It's a bit tricky, yeah.
You might get stuck at the airport in Germany. It depends. It's like if you get like... I think right now the work permit situation, when you're coming from outside, it's tricky, or it's not possible right now.
You can't right now.
And then I have a friend, he asked me, he actually got like a open work permit, he got like the work and travel visa, which is a good thing what you can get from Germany, but even they told him, in order to enter the country, you have to have a job offer. So before it was like you can just come here with a work and travel visa and then you go just apply here, but now you have to have a job offer before. And right now it's like we're not sure how stuff will work out. I'm hoping there's going to be like a rush here in fall, because this is going to be the first places where they can be able to shoot.
Yeah.
And it's going to be interesting.
I think the main problem is now everywhere that all the TV sets or film sets are on halt just because of COVID. So once that ramps up again, I think there will be an overload of jobs, I believe. Yeah. But right now it's a bit going downwards. I think it's recovering slowly and they start shooting right now. I think weather is starting shooting on Avatar.
Well, again. I think they just started again. I think they shot already something.
I think for Jurassic, they also started again shooting more plates. Okay, let's see if we missed a few more questions here. Is it important to have a reel for applying, or can you apply with an art station? I would say if you want to be in the VFX industry, you should always have a reel.
Because it's like they recruit, if you don't have a reel, some of the recruiters would say,
What is this?
Unless you're like, if you're concept artist, it's different. But if you're like, I'd say, okay, like they wanted like, and really it's nice because it's like a selection of your stuff. It's like sometimes art stations, like, oh, there's like, like we added like, oh, it's like 20 things, you go through, it's like, this is good. A reel is like, you give them also like the hierarchy, like first shot is the strongest, they see from there, and then it's just easy to pass on. And it's like, if they say, oh, we got this guy, look at the art station, some visual effects supervisor, dude, I don't have time for this.
Yeah, no one will click through those different, like we did now clicking through those links, I think they will not do it. So it's always good to just present them one link, they click on it, look at it, and decide, right? So definitely advisable to have a reel.
What is it to become texturing shaders? I should learn Arnold, V-Ray, or RenderMan. I think like it doesn't matter what you learn. I think if you want to do texturing and you should, Substance is big.
Yeah,
I think Substance is big now everywhere.
Yeah, it is pretty.
Mari doesn't hurt. And then it's like, look, I'm working in Arnold right now. Before I was working in RenderMan. And it's like, if you work in the big studios, like the renderer doesn't really matter. It's like, they give you, get a training, and then it's like, the RenderMan ILM uses is different than the ILM when you buy RenderMan. Arnold, what Arnold uses at Sony is different than out of the box Arnold. They have also, like, it's not like that you set your stuff up. It's all, you work in a big pipeline. It's
all set up. Exactly.
And it's more about the artistic, so I would say more like, or the general principles of shading and,
Just to clarify, a few people are asking, when do I review their portfolio? So because I got so many entries, we could not, like, we had like 80 emails, like 80 essentially, and obviously there's not just no time to do it. So I just used a hat and picked a random name, and I think we did like 15 probably, like if I would guess it. So if you weren't part of that, I'm sorry for this, but we might just do it another time. And I'm thinking, because like how Andrew is doing it, he's just doing a stream and then he's asking for a subscription, and we might do a similar thing, like just to get you directly, that we, that you subscribe or something, and or donate or whatever, and then we just put you up on the screen and talk about it. So I guess that is something we'll do in the future.
What else we got?
Thank you. What's the max length? Yeah.
Max length? I don't know if like, look, my reel is 1:30, and it's like, I don't know.
135,
yeah. Yeah, 135. It's like, it doesn't really, like, I don't know if you have stuff for like 3 minutes, it's like nobody's gonna, like, unless it's like super, like they want to watch it. Like if you do like 1 minute of strong stuff, that's a good length.
Yeah.
Even like okay, if you, like, there are senior artists in the industry that have working there for 20 years, they have a reel that is like 3.5 minutes, but it's not like a reel that they're gonna apply somewhere. It's more like, oh, it's kind of like a best off kind of thing. Arvid has a pretty good reel. It's
it's a bit long. Yeah.
2:13.
If we just play this, maybe, I guess most of you have seen it, but
it's pretty awesome stuff.
So again, like what I'm trying to do here is just showcase the strong work, and at least the work I think is strong in the beginning, and then I show the average pieces. Sometimes it's a bit hard to pick things, because like working on them, you have a different relationship to your reels, or at least that's what I feel.
Yeah, for sure.
So I always ask my friends, hey, how do you find this shot? Is it strong? Is it not strong? And we actually did, like, even Dennis helped me on my reel. So we did lots of iterations. Hey, remove this shot, remove that, edit it out earlier and whatnot. And yeah.
And also sometimes, like, you want to show different stuff. Okay, you got like crazy comic book stuff. Then you have like more realistic, like dinosaur integration. And it's, it's like, this is more like a game cinematic, almost like this stuff. Yeah. And it shows like some variety in it. That's good.
Yeah.
But in the beginning, it's like, okay, you have like 3 or 4 pieces, so it's easy. You take the best one, and it's like, there's no.
And that's Jurassic. Yeah, exactly. So as I said, and strong pieces, and I also have like I love the puking shot. This is actually one of my favorite, even though like there wasn't much, obviously a bit of integration, so it was mostly plate, but we had to replace armor pieces, so he has CG armor plates on it, and I think the water is obviously like a Houdini sim or whatever. I just like it. It's a fun thing, and this is also the thumbnail of my video. Just a bit ironic, I guess. But yeah, let's go full screen again. So let's see, last question, and then from question Johnny. Is
creating a reel, I do most times this for environments, and to animate it and render it, it would take a lot of time. So wait, do you have good reels with still? It's like, the question is like, where you want to go with, like, you're making environments for, what's your goal? You want to go for like movies, or you want to be like Archviz, like, because you do want to go in Archviz, like, what's it called?
Archviz
is like, stilts is fine, but for the movies, at some point they're going to ask you, okay, this is still, and the problem with what we said earlier with the still image is like, okay, is it really like, it also could be just, they don't know if it's like all 3D or is it like, it also could be painted or something. So it's hard for them to judge. So if you have three or four still images, it's fine. But if you have some kind of like moving image, would be great.
Yeah. And then also a question is,
the guy like, here's like a good real part.
Yeah.
I think I just look at it.
You can click here, but then you got to click here.
Oh yeah. I'm just looking for it. Like, where is it?
Okay.
Working.
Is it good to have a breakdown of your showreel? As you can see, I don't have one, I have maybe one, but essentially I think you don't need to have like a breakdown of all the passes, unless maybe if you work in comp, you want to see what you did. But for a lot of departments, I don't think you need a breakdown. You can obviously, if you work on a group project, like you work on a shot and there's like lots of departments, you want to definitely specify what you worked on, right? If you just did the lighting, you just gotta, if you just did the lighting, then you just obviously got to say it, right? I did the lighting. And this link here is from Dennis. It's a good one.
Sorry, I can't remember your name. Sorry.
What? You what?
I just copied it under your name. I didn't know. I was like, yeah, this is from our website. And there's basically all this stuff we're saying about the ray.
Yeah. So this is just essentially like a cheat sheet. I think you look at it and these are like all the tips you have to do or just which helps you actually make a better reel, I guess, right? So be sure to check that out on VFX Bootcamp. The link is in the chat.
Yeah.
Okay, so let's see, like, is it working on different reels? How can we grow our sense? Because you guys are awesome in your review, definitely superb. Okay, let's answer this last question and then we're done.
How can we grow sense?
I think you're asking like how do we say, okay, it needs more breakup or not, or like, and I think it just comes from experience. We both are in the industry for 10 years or something like that, right? And even a bit more. We just have seen lots of shots. We were sitting in dailies. We had a VFX sub who's giving us notes on it saying, hey, this needs more breakup. And just based on all that feedback we are getting, we build our experience, and I think that's just how you grow your sense, and it's not something you can learn from YouTube or something. It's just it takes a bit of time.
Also, like we said earlier, always like reference, right? It's like, okay, if there's look on the, like I have like a cup on the table and it's on a wood table, we take a picture on the table, it's like, okay. Yeah. I mean, like, yeah, like we put it like, and then it's like you can take a quick picture with your phone and it's like, okay, this is in a ballpark. Oh, like, oh, like the displacement of the wood looks weird. And the thing is, like we said, in dailies, the notes are it's very similar notes all the time.
Yeah.
All right, that sums it up. Thank you very much for enjoying this portfolio review. And if you give me a thumbs up, we will be definitely looking at that. And hopefully we'll be doing more streams like this. And we probably might even do a live stream, like a portfolio live stream directly on YouTube. Let me know if you want to see that more, if you're fine with it being over on Twitch. So just let me know how it goes and I will try to accommodate everyone. So thank you guys again and I will see you in the next video.